equipment were you at? Which one of the headphones?
Put that one that's, you know.
Now we're rolling with it.
What's good with your Facebook? Happy Leftover Fridays. Put them in the microwave, warm them up, grab your drink, chill. Boy, your boys is back in the building. We got Boom Radio in the building. Late Major. Major is late.
Bring me a plate, because if you're near Northside Drive, bring me a plate for yesterday's meal, because I just ate pizza and wings yesterday.
Well, no, boy, you should have said something. Boy, we ate so good. Boy,
he said pizza and wings, y'all.
Pizza and wings, man.
Boy, we had oxtails.
And
salmon. I did my jerk salmon. Then we had a pasta with salmon pasta dish. And the regular stuff too. They had the regular stuff, but boy, we ate some good.
Tuning in to the show tonight, man. This is your boy Minister Case. I'm in the house, man, with the big op.
Adopt US Kids presents What to Expect When You're Expecting a Teenager. Learning the lingo.
Today I'm going to help parents translate teen slang. Now, when a teen says something is on fleek, it's exactly like saying, that's rad. It simply means that something is awesome or cool. Another one is totes. It's exactly like saying, totally, just shorter. As in, I totes love going to the mall with Becca. Another word you might hear is jelly. Jelly is a shorter, better way to say jealous, as in, Chloe, I am like so jelly of your unicorn phone case.
You don't have to speak teen to be a perfect parent. Thousands of teens in foster care will think you're, rad just the same. To learn more, visit AdoptUSKids.org. A public service announcement brought to you by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, AdoptUSKids, and the Ad Council.
When is the best time to talk to your family about staying in touch during a disaster? When floodwaters reach your door? When wildfires are engulfing the edge of your neighborhood? Or an earthquake is destroying buildings? Or is the best time, perhaps, today? During a disaster, you may not be able to stay in touch with your family or friends as easily as you think. Go to ready.gov/communicate and make your emergency plan today. Don't wait. Communicate. Brought to you by FEMA and the Ad Council.
Have just entered the building with your boys, King and Fane. Welcome to Shop Talk and Random Ish, where conversation rules the nation and no topic is off limits.
You know, this ain't nothing but healthy conversation.
Now, welcome your hosts, Rick King and Will Fane.
Greetings, Atlanta, America, worldwide, internet. Thank you for tuning in to WWWE 1100 AM, The Real. You're on Shop Talking Randomish with King Insane and the lovely Starlight. I am Will Sane.
It's your boy Rick Hang. I'm in the building, or behind the booth, on the glass, doing the vlogs, turning the tools, cooking the breakfast, washing the dishes. It's your boy Rick Hang. I am in the building.
For those who want to see Rick's handsome face, he will be on this side of the...
You coming over here, right?
I didn't even know how to do
it. I'm swinging by. Swinging chair below.
All right, cool. The lovely Starlight is not with us tonight. Big ups to my female friend, co-host Starlight. How you doing, Miss Lady? Happy belated Thanksgiving to you. Happy belated Thanksgiving to all of the listeners of Talking Random Mitch, our family and friends out there. I hope everybody had a happy turkey day.
Tonight
we have back in the building Boom Radio's own Mr. Man. Say your name, please, for the radio folks.
Bruh Casey.
Bro, Casey is in the house tonight.
We got Minister Casey in the building with us. His Boom brethren, they running scared from us. Don't be running scared from me.
Come on, Ray William Brown.
Don't be coming. You've been starting all this mess. You finna come tired of these conversations. I'm going to get some of those opinions.
He's doing the black person thing.
He's going to be purposeful.
You better be fashionably. You better be fashion. You better have some high fashion.
He ain't cute.
He ain't cute.
Nah, he ain't cute.
Oh, you gotta be on time to judge it, bro. You gotta be on time. You ain't gotta get a job. Ugly person cannot show up to a job interview late. You can't.
I don't know if you clean though.
If you clean?
Yeah. Clean.
Okay, you better not be ugly though, still trying to get that.
A pretty woman can show up to any
job. A pretty woman can do pretty much anything they want to. Now, you talking about a man. See, a man can be ugly.
But he better come like you say, he better come strong. Yeah,
you better have on some CK1. You better have on some. You know what I'm talking about? For real.
Yes, sir. See, that's that double standard. Yeah, that's that double standard. Ugly man. Ugly man don't have no problem.
No. Ugly man don't have a problem.
Ugly man, I ain't never seen an ugly man have a problem getting women.
Who? Ugly man?
I'm sorry, I can't speak.
Right.
I can't speak to that.
You black and ugly as ever, however.
Yes,
sir.
And the jam now.
And you missed the peach sheet.
Hey, come on now. Nigga told you. But man.
But no. But if you ugly, you gotta come with some extras. You can't just come show up. You can't just be ugly and just think that you're gonna get something.
Man, I don't see big dude, ugly dude. They be giving it.
He has some money, man.
Why y'all can't hear? They keep telling me they can't hear me, man. They can run on over there to Talking Random Ish Facebook page.
Yes.
Run on over there to Rick King, Talking Random Ish. It's on live. If you can't hear me, I'm gonna sit down and run on over there with him.
Yes.
Yeah, he's still out there. Okay,
come on, I'm
going on out, man.
Shoot him if you can shoot him the link. Shoot him the link.
Yeah.
Okay.
Talk around the Facebook page.
We gotta get some young studio execs in here so that we can.
Tell them how to use the technology. Hey, y'all know what this is. This is Barbershop Talking Random Mission. This is Barbershop. Ain't no conversation taboo. Y'all know how we do it around Depot. We ain't got but one rule and one rule on the way that well.
What you say? What you mean? What you say? Just don't be mean when you say it. Rick, please tell them where to call if they want to come into the show.
Boy, if y'all want to come into Barbershop with your folk, please holler at us at 404-603-8770.
Oh, where else can they call us at, Rick?
If you're in your mammy baby, please let her know. It's not one of them 999999999999.
You remember the number? You used to call them on Saturday nights.
Please let mama know it's not one of them 999.
With some socks and Vaseline beside you when you call.
I'm not going to say this conversation won't get freaky, Dicky, but it's not a freaky.
Wait a minute.
Too many grown men in here.
Too many grown men.
We ain't got the women in here tonight to get freaky.
Y'all know like I know. Men have the most freaking nigga conversation because we be talking. Come on now.
Well, you know, I ain't gonna amen that. I'm sorry.
Y'all talking about y'all escapades?
Old things have passed away. Behold, all things have become new. You know what I'm saying? That kind of stuff I leave in the past.
But I'm just saying, in the past, whatever. All right.
Okay, let's see. Facebook, can I get a pass tonight? If they try to lure me into some of this conversation.
When you was out the world.
But he tell me not be not deceived. Even communication corrupts good manners. So I can't really I can't really dive into too much stuff like that because it'll start gearing your actions toward that way.
Well,
I agree with you on that.
That's the book. You ain't got to get.
If you start thinking
with that, that's the book.
Listen, man, I got me some M&M here, man. I got me some of these jelly beans, man. Y'all leave me alone tonight.
Oh, you come sugared up tonight.
I'm come sugared up tonight.
That sound like you're
ready. And I got my cherry, wild cherry.
Sound like you're ready.
I'm good.
Sound like you're ready. I'm making a run to the package store. You need something for that, too?
I'm going to go do the break.
You know, it's after things, we being thankful.
Can't keep that brown. Can't keep it down. Make me frown. White, I drank all night. Straight to the face, no chase.
He got a rhyme for that. You know what
I use that one. I want
to
bring it
brown, I can't keep it down and make it frown. But I drank that white all night. Straight to the face, no chase. They say when the thin man know his stuff, he really rough. Hey, Facebook, y'all know I'm sick. You know I was stupid before I got here.
I'm talking about, boy.
You know I was stupid before I got here, man. I'm good people, man. I'm really glad, but nah.
Hey, man, what's been good? How was your turkey day? How was your day of thankfulness, man?
Well, you know, every day for me, I'm thankful.
Okay.
You know, be honest, every day for me, I'm thankful. Appreciate everybody for tuning in by way of Facebook to the show tonight. It was great, man. Me and my wife, you know, we empty nesters. All our kids are grown.
So y'all just walk around the house naked.
Bucket naked. In the nude.
Boy,
showing our public house.
Y'all got public house. Bucket naked.
I do like my boy do on Y'all know if y'all see the show Goldbergs. I'm a boy, my boy Daddy walking there. He just drop his pants at the floor, at the door.
Yes, sir.
That's how I do it. I just bend them tighter, whiter right there. Now, I'm tighter, whiter, but I drop them right there.
Please don't wear the tighter, whiter.
It was good. My sister, my mom passed last year in October, so.
Sorry to hear that.
No, it's okay. He's a part of life.
But that's, go ahead.
So,
yes, sir.
We didn't really celebrate Thanksgiving last year. That was the first time last year, but without my mom. And so this year, my sister invited me, my younger sister, and my big brother over to her house. Wasn't really feeling, because I already made up my mind that we were just going to stay home.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, of course, I called and talked to him, but me and the wife just stayed home. And grandbabies came over, man, so, you know, they wanted to see Pawpaw. So that was a blessing to see that third generation and my oldest son.
Did your mom,
and
not to cut you off, but did your mom still, was she still cooking before?
Oh, man, she going to stay at my house for free?
So okay, now that's got to be is it the same? Thanksgiving. Now I know the loss is a big mm-hmm. loss. So it's not the same. I know that far.
Mm-hmm.
But far as the meal,
my wife cooked. You know, shouts out to Couture Hugh, my wife, my queen, my acorn boom.
Get your cook, baby. Don't get in trouble now if you can't answer.
Okay, sir, my wife never really was like a cook.
Yeah.
You know, I got paperwork. You know, quote unquote, I got paperwork to say I can cook. So I can cook. I mean, I got paperwork. Yeah,
they call the military gave you that paper. That don't mean you can cook.
Hey, man, I can cook. Trust me. No, you got to ask my wife.
You just bull bags now.
No, I ain't talking about gorilla cooking. I'm serious. I recipe card cook and I garnish cook. I can cook for real.
Okay.
And I can, you know, I was on my own at 14, so I can cook.
Yes, sir.
My wife makes things. Now I can say this because my mom's gone now. Man, my mama would make some serious biscuits and cornbread.
Yeah.
Man, my wife, bro. And my mama taught my wife how to make cornbread.
She get to it.
Oh, they got together like
that? Bruh. Because my mom, before my mom passed, my mom stayed with me for like the house I have now.
Yeah.
It was a blessing that we got it because the reason we got it were to, so my mom can have a place to stay.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
You know, moving from auntie house to auntie house. So, like, yes, Lord bless us with a house. Mama, you come, you got your own room, you got your own bathroom. You ain't got to ever worry about no bills. You just live.
Yes.
You know, and her only thing was, you know, you had to let the dog in and out, and you had to cook every
I'm trying to do
again.
The same thing for my pops, man. I'm trying to tell my pops.
Yeah, I mean, it's a blessing, though, you know.
Yeah.
But she, you know, she loved our sisters, and, you know, so she really didn't want to stay home because it's a tight community.
Mm-hmm.
But she was by herself.
Where
so
you from?
She would sit home. I'm straight out of Grady.
Okay.
She would sit home for, but I live across the Union City.
Okay.
So she would stay in the house for a couple of days. Then, you know, she'd get bored, sitting in a rocking chair, watching the TV. Then she want to go to one of auntie's house.
Yeah.
She'd go over there 2-3 weeks. Then she'd come back home for 4-5 days. Then she'd go up to the other one house.
Yeah.
You know, that mama did what she did. And she passed and but Thanksgiving, my wife threw down, man. My wife threw down. She,
that's good,
she cooked. She threw. My sister can cook.
She cooked.
See, I'm Thanksgiving is that one for me.
Okay.
Now, what do you mean that one?
I don't do. I'm not a holiday guy. I don't do holiday.
Okay.
I don't care nothing for them. None. But that Thanksgiving is the nostalgicness, if that's a word.
I miss it, man. Yeah.
Because the smells.
Yeah. Yeah.
The smells from Wednesday.
Traditions. Yeah.
To everybody. The smells in the house.
Yeah.
Wow.
That lets you know. That's love. That love is in the house. That family. That's the. If nothing else, that's when you know family coming through.
Mm-hmm.
If ain't nothing but to get a plate.
Mm-hmm.
Nephew, come on through. Mama cooking. Nephew.
Yeah.
Nephew gonna come on through. You know, if it ain't that, but it's just the smells of the house. It's the nostalgic vibe. This nostalgic feeling of just family, and that's why the hate. The job that I have, because I'm only all I have to be back. I had to be back to work,
right.
So I hadn't been able to be at home with my dude on that day. But it's just that's what I love about Thanksgiving. I don't care about the rest of that mess. Don't mean nothing to me. It's just something about the family breaking bread and just being there at that one time, and everybody. You know, trying to show, you know, everybody trying to show off their dish, you know. And
you said something that's kind of, you know, sparked a thought here, man. Don't nobody try to steal this. You heard it here right now from Minister Casey right here on Talking Random Mish. All right. You mentioned some smell. Maybe we need to come out with some kind of Glade air freshener. We come out with some kind of air freshener.
Man.
You know, Thanksgiving that smells like that smell like dressing and
big mama nails.
Yeah,
you know
what
I'm saying? That just give you calories smelling.
Boy, you calories smelling this air.
Especially when you open that door.
Yeah.
That front door and them things that just hit you.
It just hits out.
Oh my God.
Man, my brother called me early in the morning. Time, what you doing? I was in there, you know, I stayed in my onesie, you know what I'm saying, all day long. That was my whole day. My Falcon onesie. Yeah. And I was playing Madden. I woke up drinking coffee playing Madden. My brother called me, man, probably about 8 o'clock in the morning. Talking about, man, what's good? I said, no, he's talking about, man, I'm just trying to find me somewhere to go looking for some big feet and some big feet.
Hey, man.
I said, no, man, you ain't getting no pig ears and pig, man. You know I don't eat that stuff, man. He's talking about, well, I do. I said, look around over Shannaboo house, man. I can't.
Hey, man,
that.
I ain't going to lie. One time, but y'all eat them chitlins.
No, bro.
No, never. I've never eaten chitlins,
man,
bro.
And then one time, hey, I ain't gonna,
never.
Can't no more. I got, like I said,
one time a year,
I make a little bit more money now. I ain't gotta eat that part of pigs.
Hey, bro.
Like,
hey, bro.
Nah, bro.
I ain't gonna turn my back on it. Once a year. Mom, dude, they'll make it. They'll make sure they have me a little bowl.
I could never
do
that.
I gotta apologize to my family because I know it's like I don't go down for Thanksgiving anymore, and I'm like a extrovert?
Introvert.
I'm like an introvert when it comes now to Thanksgiving, I know it's all had to do with my mom passing.
Yeah.
You know, years ago, about 10, 11 years ago, when my mom passed.
Welcome.
It all changed for me. Because now, it's like the tradition to me was always, okay, Wednesday night, my mom, my sisters, and whomever would be actually in the kitchen cooking.
In the kitchen cooking, yes, sir.
My dad would be out on the grill, like smoking a turkey and everything.
Smoking a turkey.
And then I'd be there just hanging out, chilling, you know, running to hang, talking to my dad or whatever, hanging with my partners and everything. But once my mom passed, it's like we started going to everybody else's house. Oh, we're going to eat at her house. We're going to eat at their house. Nah, I don't. Sorry, y'all, but I don't do that. I don't like going to everybody.
Yeah.
And nothing against my family members. I love y'all. Trust me. But my thing was, I wanted to always be in my family house.
In your family house.
Yeah. So once that changed, when that dynamic changed and my mom left, I was like, you know, I just stay up here. I stay up here with me and my kids.
But that's your family. Y'all don't have y'all own.
You know, I screwed up this year. My bad, Doc. I know you're mad at me still. But what a tradition was.
Not gonna bust you in your head.
Not gonna bust me in my head.
Not gonna bust you on their head.
But
man,
what we usually do is we take the kids to go do the, feed the needy.
Yeah.
I ain't say needy, but feed the folks and everything, deliver meals.
They need it.
You know,
they need.
He put headphones on, man.
Y'all don't lie?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Oh.
What you think?
I know y'all don't lie.
Got
right
the Murray
in
the house.
Hey, the main that started all this, man, is in the finer in the building.
Who started what?
You
started.
We're getting to it.
When did I start?
Man, it's been about 3 weeks you done started a conversation. You can't get them all out. We getting them out tonight. We getting all that mess out tonight, my brother. But first of all, we just talking about...
Inbox me that.
But we talking about Turkey Day.
Thanksgiving. Yep.
Yes, sir. The day of thank. And how was yours?
I mean, I ain't do nothing. I just chilled.
That's how it is. Did you have traditions growing up as a kid, and now it's like you ain't with the same traditions, or you don't have traditions now?
Yeah, I had traditions growing up as a kid. Especially my mom's household.
Yeah.
But you know, now I haven't celebrated Thanksgiving in probably at least 10 years.
What
I mean celebrate, I'm saying as far as within my house. Mm-hmm. Now, when there have been friends and people like that that have had Thanksgiving I went over just to, hang out, that type of thing, or chop it up with them, especially if somebody came from out of town or a relative that I haven't seen. But as far as my wife, you know, saying, hey, we're going to, have turkey and dress and all that type of stuff, you know, in honor of.
Well, see that's not, that's what we're talking about when you came in. For me, it's a nostalgic feeling of just kicking it with family.
Yeah. Right.
And that starts on Wednesday night when Mon Duke is in there mixing that dressing.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
And got that pot ball and ready to put them greens in.
Yeah.
It's just those smells. It's just that's what it is for me, because as far as the celebrate, I don't get
it. Hey, yeah, the Pilgrims, Native American.
Nah,
it's never been Pilgrims are Native Americans. That part never crossed my household.
We never sat there and said, thank God for Europeans coming in and Native Americans teaching them how to hunt and grow corn.
Maybe. Ain't never care about none of that.
Nah.
You know, that never crossed in our household. We never had the decorations, anything. Any of that.
It's about breaking bread with your family.
Yeah.
It's that one day that we knew that the family was going to actually get together and it wasn't a funeral.
And hear the old stories from the older folks tell the old stories. Yes. You know, your aunts and uncles come around talking about how they used to be as kids and all.
Yes.
That's the part that I miss for my kids, because my kids don't get to experience that, because my kids are up here.
Mine don't either.
They don't get to experience me and my sisters and my cousins all sitting at the table talking about our childhood and my kids looking and da-da-da-da. Like I got the experience when I was young.
Yes, sir.
That's the part I feel.
Question. Do you think, like, some of these, a day like that, is that a day that traditions can be passed down, whether they be spiritual or even, like, you know, family? Different things that happens in families, different stories. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? That's a time where, let's say, 3-4 generations. Like, you there with, you know, if my mom was living, I'm here with my mom, and then I got my son, and then I got my grandbabies. Yeah. That's 4 generations that's in the household. That's a blessing.
Yeah, that's a blessing.
Are you talking about 4 on Thanksgiving Day?
Not necessarily that day, but any day.
You make a family day.
I think Thanksgiving make a day because, you know, you off that day.
All right.
McDonald's was still low.
We need to call it a Big Mama Day.
Yeah.
I mean, Big Mama Day. Everybody in the family come to
now
that.
Now, what I hate is, what you get to is what the world think of it at. Because I don't even think the world thinks of that anymore. Most of them don't.
I'm telling you, I think that's gone.
I just think it's really about, for me, it's about the wake up. Because for years, once I got married, my kids were sick every year around Thanksgiving.
Mm-hmm.
So me and their mama had to get up early and go run over to the store for clothes and pick up everything, and we had to cook them. And that almost came a tradition in our house that we were cooking and had some stories and listening to music. And it was just, for some reason, it just is a family gathering.
Yeah.
I'm going to tell you, and I think the brother, he said it earlier, he said it's not anymore for us. You know, like what Casey's saying about the family tradition of things. At one point in time, Thanksgiving transitioned into, you know, the black household as a family gathering of things. Mm-hmm. As time passed, even though we know the origin of it shouldn't be celebrated.
Yeah,
but
right.
At the same time, when the black household did accept it and start celebrating it, it became more about a family thing. Then also, even the churches got on board, mm-hmm, with saying, okay, well, this particular day, we're going to reverence this day as a day of thanks to the Lord.
Yeah.
This is what the church said. But as time has passed, and to his point, it has transitioned away from even, mm-hmm, honoring God. To the point to where now it becomes more about the food.
I think it's more so about being thankful for whatever you want to consider yourself thankful for.
Right, but
the food is just to bring everybody together.
Right, but most people, when they have in their households, most people think or have a conversation more about the food. Mm-hmm. Even when it comes down to gathering together and saying, there isn't too many people pray before they eat anymore.
See?
That's true.
So when you start even looking at it, even as a family, now it's become, even the churches, they don't even have service on Thanksgiving no more.
Hold on, before we get this mess started.
On Thanksgiving.
Who the hell are you? And why you in my box? You coming in here changing nigga? Who are you?
Yeah, because he didn't say that.
Yes, sir. Who are you?
Saying,
yeah, no, who are you, man? You got a word now. Who are you? And why you in my barbershop, man? Who are you?
I'm William Brown.
And that's it. The hell? Who are you?
William Brown, what do you do?
What
do you do?
I work a job, working 9-to-5.
Okay, now after you 9-to-5, what do you do?
Do you have a show, William Brown?
I have a show.
What's the name of your show, William Brown? Why we got to bring it out of you? Why we got to coach it out of you?
Because I just came here.
You do this for a living as well. Why we coaching
it? But okay, yes, you are, brother. but you are a brother of what? And what role do you play of that?
Well, let me ask you a question. He asked, do we have a show? Yes, we have a show here on the first and third Saturday called Boom Radio.
What does that mean? What is Boom Radio? What does it mean?
Boom Radio is named after our congregation, Believers of One Messiah. So I'm the Moray, which means teacher in Hebrew, over Boom Church.
Huh.
And so we have our show, and you are the engineer of our show.
the honorarium.
He's the honorary member of the show. He's also a member as well, who brought a lot of diversity and life to our show. And so now I'm here on my brother's show, and with my other brother sitting here, and now I get a chance to meet you and we get into it.
Good to have you.
This is not my first time in the barbershop.
It's not your first time?
No.
I wasn't here the last time.
Yeah, of course not. Of course you would.
That's what we had
the conversation. But
that'd be at work more often.
Explain to my listeners what is Boom, what is the origin of...
Like, how did y'all come together and decide that, hey, you know what, you meet up, how do y'all meet up and then say, hey, we're going to do a show?
Give us kind of sort of the history. Because it's interesting, because it's very interesting.
Like, y'all made a jill or some shish, and it was like, hey, brother, we need to go. Hey, you know what? I did wrong, you did wrong.
Give us the history, because
what happened?
At 9 o'clock, we going to talk about
everything.
That mess you started had me talking about, that other mess you had me talking about, and then you sent me a video, and we gonna get into all that. So give us.
Oh, he sent the video.
He sent the video.
All right, cool.
So give us the history of Boom and what it is. Yeah, basically, what is Boom? To give us an understanding. Give our audience an understanding.
You got 5 minutes. Origin. Go.
Boom Church. Again, Believers of One Messiah is a Messianic Hebrew or Hebrew Israelite congregation. Me and Casey, we met a couple years ago when he was at a Christian church, and I came over to rap during that youth service.
Spit, like rap, or just like the rap talk?
Rap, spit.
Okay, all right.
And we met there, and then a couple years later.
Now, he secretly got some lyrics, but yeah.
A couple years later, we linked up and met through two, his former pastor and my former pastor. My pastor kind of told me to link up with him because he was, you know, kind of the heathen in nature.
Oh, you were
the heathen. Causing problems.
You were the heathen. Now, Rick, the heathen.
That's why I get that, why we kind of connect.
Causing problems. And so they asked me to link up with him because, you know, a lot of things he was speaking against that was in the speaking out in the church was truth, dealing with a lot of things that were pagan within the church structure. Mm-hmm. And so, I was in, you know, knowing who I was an Israelite and things like that. And so me and him linked up, and I was, during the time I was traveling, doing a lot of teaching. I had my own tour called the Truth Tour, which I was teaching biblical history and things like that. And
was it so, just like throughout the state, or was it like
it was
Southeast wide,
no,
nationwide?
It was like nationwide.
Okay.
And so Casey went to a couple of, he traveled with me a couple of times, and then it came up, and I just was like, hey, man, you know, we're going to start a church and a congregate, because more people was wanting to know the history of things that really wasn't being taught in the church.
Yeah.
And so that's how it kind of, you know, got started, with just a group of people. And then we kind of grew from there, and we got a couple of churches, you know, and stuff like that.
Hold up.
Even in Africa.
You said Hebrew Israelite.
Yeah.
Ain't them some damn fools? If I type in right now, if I go to YouTube,
non-camp,
and I type in
non-camp,
you gotta put that disclaimer out, non-camp.
They get into it.
Yeah, I mean, in every sect of belief, there are some damn fools.
Yeah,
there's some damn fools in Christianity. There's some in Islam. There's some in the Hebrew Israelite community. There's some in atheism. I mean,
So I guess my question is Boom Radio part of the Hebrew Israelites that's on the corner that
nah.
that's causing
chaos that's gotten us on the terrorist extreme terrorist.
Okay, I'm missing something here. Yeah, what am I missing?
Okay, back a couple months ago, I guess the biggest way the back a couple months ago in DC,
they had an encounter with some MAGA, Make America Great Again people. Indigenous.
Native American guy and those guys.
Okay, well, the black guys, they were Hebrew Israelites.
Okay, gotcha.
And they traditionally wear, don't they have traditionally long?
They wear certain garments and stuff like that. Depending on which one, they wear different colors and stuff like that. So all Israelites don't hold the same biblical worldview.
Yeah.
Just like every other religion. You know, you have Sunnis and Shiites.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. A lot of them don't hold the same biblical.
I know that. I learned that in social studies.
even in Kemet.
What school you went to? White folks school then?
View in Kemet.
Okay.
He said he didn't learn that in social studies.
I learned that one in social studies. I learned about it.
We don't get that in public schools.
Well, we get it in public schools. No. I don't think we do anymore now. Because I think they want to label all as bad. So they don't separate or get as in depth about it anymore. We gotta take a break real quick.
We gonna get ready to take a break. I'm glad you broke that down for us, Moray, William, and because like I said, when we gonna come back, you sent me a video about a week ago, and you thought we wasn't gonna touch on.
Nah.
Yes, yeah. But and
this is the LGBTQ.
Yeah. The Flame and Roll. The video with Flame and Roll.
LGBTQ.
Yes. And for the last about month, he been really hot. He want to talk about Kanye West.
You want to talk about
Ye? He this man.
Kanye.
We gonna have a conversation.
Kanye put his. He the one started this. I ain't start this.
You started.
And Kanye started this.
He was also the one that brought to light the to us the conversation about Alicia Keys.
Oh, okay.
And the son, her son and everything.
So, all right, so what we're going to do, we're going to take a break. When we come back from break, we're going to dive back a few weeks back into some of the past conversations that we had, which were sparked by conversations Rick had with our host, the host of Boom Radio, our guest today tonight. Thank you very much. Yeah,
we're going to let him finish the cover because actually what he does...
Let's just go to break. We'll talk about it on the back list.
What he does on his show is he like to start the conversation, then he step back.
Go to break.
Let him fight it out.
That's over tonight, Murray. It's over.
Go to break. Pay these bills.
Hey, man. Run on to...
You are tuned into WWE Lakeville. AM 1100.
The opinions expressed during the sponsored programs on this station are strictly those of the program hosts, guests, and callers and are not necessarily those of Beasley Broadcast Group, this station, its staff, other advertisers, or agencies.
Coming to...
Yeah. I ain't your average rapper residing in Calabasas, mashing the Aston through Malagasy and Madagascar. I don't believe in your white Jesus and Last Suppers. I place value on brothers who never had justice. I am the black savage, Ali informing and Zaya fighting for black magic. Rifles and flak jackets, mama was suicidal, papa had bad habits, product of true survival. Rocking like Black Sabbath, hopping about the Chevy, Pac, Biggie, Machiavelli, OG like Nas or Reggie, culture like Oxenbelly, Vogue like Akinelli, focus like Dr. Sebi. We did it your way, but now the culture is popping to our Sinatra medley. I'm limitless energy, they gimmicks and imagery. Kendrick Cole and the Kennedys, lyrical holy trinity. General of the city, they end up promoting silly beef. Keeping it willy deep, Weezy only a milli beat. Dream chaser facing the enemy like an enemy. Tyler Perry writing my winning speech like it's Emmy week. Heart of gold, never sold my soul. Glock weighs a ton. Hov telling Lori Harvey no with Rock Nation brunch.
One life to live, just don't settle. One life, I'ma live forever. Stand for something, fall for nothing, no. Rest in peace, the dead, that's on my soul. You only die once and then you go. Who know we be fighting all alone? Who don't know the rights from the wrong? Truth comes to the light behind
how
it all.
How much more do you want? You wanna send us back to where we came from, cause we just savages. Well, here's my sad kiss, yeah, yeah. I made a gold mine and I go back home, I'm a gold mine and we taking all the land back, they stole mine and cause what you reap now is what you sold mine. We're getting away your soul, mine, goddamn.
One life to live, just don't settle. One life, I'ma live for and fall. Stand for something, fall for nothing, no. Rest in peace, the dead, that's on my soul. You only die once and there you go. Who know we be fighting all alone? Who don't know the rights from the wrong? Truth comes to the light behind it all.
If I rule the world, I would go return all of the gold that was stole. Reupholster the nose on the Sphinx, it's a world war. Huh, they tryna take the soul out of soul. Need to say I sold out, I never sold out a show. Even though people drove out in droves, plus a whole lot of hoes, I suppose. On the road to success, you gotta pay the toll, I was told. I don't hang with pawns, I'm Genghis Khan. Slain with a gang of cons that came with guns, who speak the language from the ancient ones. Dangerous, huh, we shining, nigga, shame the sun. Do I move deep? Or stay a Saint Laurent, cause y'all fashion week in the Saint Milan. Calusa to your one Ponce de Leon. Make sure it's peppercorn sauce on my filet mignon, my nigga.
One life to live, just don't settle. One life, I'ma live for and fall. Stand for something, fall for nothing, no. Rest in peace, the dead, that's on my soul. You only die once and then you go. Who know we be fighting all along? Who don't know the rights from the wrong? Truth comes to the light behind.
My favorite action rate, my hands up alone, my antenna. Cynic, we born sinner. Killer, cause we want dinner. Try to warn, better keep on growing, try to stay away from foreign. Better recognize when the devil show his horns. He enjoying his horns like Donald Gorns. It's the difference between Yorn and Tamika and Lauren. Young Warren Buffett in his prime, he ain't even knowing. How she supposed to get thick, you just be feeding her corn. With your corny every day, bro, why she dunking on your head, you know? Go to jail, tell it all before you ask for your attorney, yeah. But you can never be me. Knew who I was before I got out the trap to sell a CD. I've been shoulder to shoulder with gangsta facing LAPD. Felony after felony, still to be yelling me free. Now my philosophy is no possession, no apostrophe. Cause ain't no use in being in prison, you ain't got to be. Ironically, we got the crazy crap with hammer. Just how they use the dog, we hit with braids and bandana. Man, they been more mad killing than the days in the year. One day fighting for it, worth it much of leaving it here. I'm saying.
One life to live, just don't say. One life, I'ma live for and fall. Stand for something, fall for nothing, no. Rest in peace, the dead, that's on my soul. You only die once and then you go. Who thought we be fighting all along? Who don't know the rights from the wrongs? Truth comes to the light behind it all.
Welcome back, welcome back, welcome back to Barbershop Talking Random-ish with your boys, King and Sane. I am Rick Kane, the man behind the glass, the man that darting the knobs, the man that doing this. I'm cooking the yams, I'm cleaning the chitlins, I'm doing it all. It's your boy, Rick Kane. I am in the building.
What's good? What's good, people? I am Will Sane. The lovely Starlight is not in the building tonight, but we do have the host of Boom Radio, who are on our sister station at Love 680.
Love 860.
Love 860. I forgot.
You don't know your own sister.
Yeah, we got kicked out.
They kicked us off.
Yeah,
wow. Because no conversation is taboo in the barbershop.
Rick said some bad words that can't be said on that station, so we got kicked off.
Yeah, we got evicted. So.
Is it the same size antenna? Who got a bigger antenna?
Nah.
Same size
I don't know. Hey, during this time of the year, AM is hurting big time.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Well, we're back. Shop Talking Random-ish. So, we got some conversations, like we said before the break. There's some conversations that we need to jump into that were sparked by conversations which were on Boom Radio, which they didn't get resolved because one person, Mr. Will Brown. Will Brown, right?
Yeah, you can call me that.
Mr. Will Brown started the conversation.
Now, what he like to do...
What is this? He starts it up?
Yeah, he's an antagonist. What he like to do... Yeah, he like to come in, do his thing...
Mr. Anderson.
Sprinkle some of the word on it, and then he let me and Casey...
Clash.
Yeah, go at it.
Oh, you like the referee?
No, I give everybody a fair shot, man. Give everybody a fair shot.
You started up to say, let's get it out.
Give everybody a fair shot. Even the Hebrew Barry White.
Derek Solomon.
But he be that back. He chill. Yeah. He'll say some, and then he'll lay all the way back. And then, for some reason, me and Casey
always end up.
Always into it.
Y'all always end up. I think it is that sometimes, you know, you feel as though you're not respected because you're behind the glass. Sometimes that fuels his testosterone.
I mean, with no,
oh, say something.
That's what it is. No, but it don't, man. I'm just saying, man, especially when he started talking about his favorite subject of Kanye West, because for some reason.
So let's go to Kanye West. All right, so now, how do you feel? Like, what's your? You have an issue with Kanye? Do you have an issue with Kanye? And if so, what is the issue?
I don't think we've ever got that far because he'll start.
He'll be the one, yeah.
And then he'll be quiet.
So let's see what the issue is. Do you have an issue with Kanye?
My only issue with Kanye West is I have a musical issue with Kanye.
Okay, so it's not about his "quote unquote Christianity." I'm doing my Jesus congregation thing right now.
I don't think he's a Christian yet.
Okay.
I think he's transitioning into that.
Okay. So your thing with Kanye is about the music side of the house.
Yeah, I feel as though I'm still upset that we got the dark version of Kanye. We got, you know, you have the what's his name? Venom.
Yeah.
Spider-Man.
Yeah.
For a while we've gotten.
What's that mesothelioma? What's the stuff called that when they get? I know it. I can't think of the name of it.
Mesothelioma.
No. What is it called in Spider-Man when the black stuff get on you and you turn into Venom?
Metamorphosis.
No, it's called something. I'm not a comic book freak like that. But I just know that it's something. It's a name for it.
Yeah. He became Venom, and so that's kind of my thing. My whole issue with the Kanye thing, it's just musically. I want
a better Kanye music.
I want the old Kanye. But
it's like Jay-Z said, if you want the old Jay, then buy my old album. Same thing with Kanye. Right. If you want the old Kanye, buy my old album.
I mean, I think because what music was, I think that Kanye would have fit the time, especially since I've been robbed for so many years of a non-Jay Electronica album. I don't know if any of y'all know about Jay Electronica. Yeah,
I know. Who's that guy? Who's Jay Electronica? Who's that guy?
He teased me with signing to The Rock, and then all of a sudden, we never got album. He teased us on several mixtapes, and that was about it.
I think some people are just mixtape people, though.
No, I think some people. But how do you know what Jay is?
I feel that some people are mixtape people, but they're not album people.
I don't think that's the problem with Jay. Okay. I just think Jay is. I'm not gonna worry about you. We talking about
because the reason why I say that is because of how music has changed now. Like if Jay Electronica was very talented, put out an album versus Future's album. Future's album's gonna sell more than Jay Electronica.
But
because of the demographic who's buying.
But he got a cult. Jay Electronica still has a cult. We still waiting on.
Yeah.
But Future's.
We still.
It's Jay Electronica album is like us waiting on Detox.
Okay.
Yeah, exactly.
It's like so long to the point where it's like I'm not even, you know.
Yeah.
I'm not even thinking about
Hop a Hoodie, people.
He even gonna drop Detox when he drop out. Detox is Dr. Dre. Smoke been Dr. Dre.
Yeah.
No, I know Detox. I'm talking about the other
guy.
See, exactly.
I've been at the game so long.
You're a prime example of what I'm saying.
But no, Jay Electronica.
Everyone doesn't know about Jay Electronica.
Right, but at the time when Jay Electronica came out, Jay Electronica was probably the most successful underground artist without an album.
Okay.
Wow.
And I'm talking about he had such a buzz because what he did was he took a lot of Jay Dilla beats, mm-hmm. a lot of stuff from Big L, and he rapped over it.
Mm-hmm.
And his mixtapes were so dope to the point to where he was doing shows and he had bidding wars. He was doing so many shows in Europe. He has a worldwide fan base that's underground.
Wow.
To the point to where that's the record that just this is Jay Electronica. And that record was produced by Jeff Blaze.
Man, when this came out,
that record.
I
never heard
that.
I ain't gonna lie to you.
I've never heard it.
That record.
I hear that one. I ain't gonna lie to you.
Ladies and gentlemen,
he's taking too long. Speed it up. Get to some words instead of the conversation.
I won't hear the drop.
I want to hear some words. It's taking too long.
Nah.
It's taking too long. Get to it. Let's go. It's taking too long, though, man. We got listeners trying to hear conversations, and we waiting for somebody to say something. People don't want to just hear a beat. Keep going. Come on.
When I was sleeping on the train, sleeping on Lesero Lab out in the rain, without even a single slice of pizza to my name. Too proud to beg for change, mastering the pain. When New York niggas was calling Southern rappers lame, but then
right, now cut it real quick. Nice.
I would
guess
lie.
What? It ain't gonna sell more in the future.
Listen.
And that's fact. No, come on, stop. That's fact.
Hold on. I think we're underestimating. But the reason why you're saying that is because you know future.
No. Because I know kids nowadays. Kids will wear the box. These kids are paying to hear what's the dude just got 6'9".
Listen,
people are paying to hear 6'9" rap before they listen to that.
Listen. You're saying that because you know Future. You don't know Jay Electronica. And you don't know his fan base. I'm telling you. I'm trying to tell you.
It's not the same as we thought.
Okay, check this out. Do you know who Jay Electronica is dating?
No.
And I'm going to tell you how big he is.
How big he is? Because I don't know who he's dating.
He's not on TMZ. Do you know who
has Jay Electronica been on TMZ?
Yes. Yes.
When?
But here's the thing.
About what?
Do you know who he's with?
I'm asking you a question. Has Jay
Electronica?
Listen.
President Obama wanted his dollar.
No.
I'm just saying. Bigger than that.
Oh, what is it?
What? I can't even think of.
He's with a Rothschild.
Yeah,
are you familiar with a Rothschild?
Yeah, I'm familiar with a Rothschild. You know, they inbred.
He's with a Rothschild.
They inbred. Okay. Not inbred like so sexually, but
That's his old lady.
Okay, but okay.
He's a Rothschild.
He's with a Rothschild.
She's with him.
Okay, that's cool.
Yeah.
But he don't know who the hell he is.
No.
You screaming about he's with a Rothschild. He's with somebody.
What I'm trying to explain to you is.
Not known.
What I'm trying to explain to you is his base.
His fan base.
Is bigger than Future's.
Yeah.
That's what I'm trying to get you to understand.
He can go do shows.
He's
got this. This cat got 3 songs. He can go do shows.
I'm going to say something to you.
All right. That's what I'm saying.
No, I'm going to say something to you.
How do we get on him off Kanye?
Let's talk about what makes sense, all right? You're telling me he was with a Rothschild. You're telling me his fan base is so big, but nobody's putting out his album. Then what's the problem?
He hasn't done it.
So he's the one.
Yes, he hasn't done it. Yeah, he's the one.
And he still, to my knowledge, he's still signed to the Rock.
Every major.
That doesn't make sense.
Record company and record exec was damn near chasing this dude to sign him.
Okay, so then the Rothschilds got him in the mind.
No, he stopped doing it because he got a child with Erykah Badu. He also has a child.
Yes.
And that's what's his problem.
You can have
Dre 3000, I love you. DOC, I love you. Erykah, I love you, but I am scared of you. Because anybody gets with Erykah.
Hey, you got that sunshine.
Man, I don't know what it is with Erykah, man.
But she can pull out a hell of a... If she would have started a group...
I can't mess with Erykah,
with just her baby daddy?
God, night.
Wow. Oh, my God.
I'm scared of Erykah, bro.
Hey, I'm wondering what the alimony is.
I think Kanye done been with Erykah.
I don't know.
He got worse than that. He got a Kardashian.
But Erykah is worse.
Wow. Erykah mind blows people, man.
No, I have not seen... I was watching the interview with Bilal. You know Bilal?
Yes. He's in food too, though.
I was watching the interview with Bilal.
Yeah.
And Bilal said that Erykah hooks men before they even get into bed.
I can believe that.
Yeah. Erykah hooks men just by her eyes.
I can believe that. Wow. She has a nice
Men, he said, you can't. It's the same thing.
Kind of like Betty Davis, huh?
Yeah.
Same thing that Jamie Foxx was making a joke about Prince, right?
Yeah.
Hey, goddamn, look.
Yeah.
You know, but exactly. he said Erica Eyes makes you want to go deeper into who she is.
Yeah, you don't want to
just... That sounds like a witch.
You look at more than just the physical.
But every guy that's been with her, the only one that she didn't mess up, they mind...
Doc?
Was D.O.C.
Yeah, Doc. Doc was the only one.
Andre
got messed up.
Andre
changed. No.
Andre was already sick. He was already like that.
He was supposed to be like that on camera. No, he was not.
No.
Andre started wearing the
turban. Common went crazy.
Everybody.
Now, Jay.
Maybe it's the weed.
Jay Electronica was already.
No, I want you. D.O.C. is the only person.
I can't say he's. I don't know what he is, because even in his music, he make references to the NOI.
And the 5%.
Yes. So I don't know what his position is as far as doctrine. You know what I'm saying? Because he makes references to both.
Yeah.
But I mean, Jay was already kind of nuts, so I guess.
How are you making references to the NOI and the 5%, but he's dating a Jew? That don't even make sense.
Hey.
So I don't even see Jay Electronica. All right, let's go back to Kanye. See, that don't even make sense right there. Let's go back to Kanye. So your thing with Kanye is more musical than anything else. Then it stems from the music. You feel like you're getting robbed from the greatness of which was Kanye to what he's doing right now. Because I do feel that Kanye has gotten into that, especially with the song Closed on Sunday. I feel that Kanye has gotten to that realm where Jay-Z and a lot of other artists go, as to where I can say anything or put out anything and people gonna buy it.
He's been past that.
No, I think Kanye is worse, because at least Jay tried it.
Jay throws out garbage and just says, "Hey, I'm Jay-Z, people gonna buy it." That's why I stopped buying stuff, and I started actually just poaching off of
that
YouTube.
I still don't feel that album.
That
was a grown man hip hop album, but
I never bought a Jay-Z album.
I mean,
you don't feel that.
You can't expect, people do grow, you know what I'm saying?
True.
And depend on their experiences, you know, what they dealing with. I just think that the situation which Kanye went to when he transitioned to Venom was after his mom died.
I think
he should have took a break.
Yeah.
But he can't start, and then it don't make it any better. You get with a Kardashian, which you know,
I don't know, but
I love the Kardashians.
He thought somebody was trying to kill him too.
I'm sure you would.
Yeah,
you get with Kardashian, but you won't get with.
I mean, you never know the pressure.
I won't. Yeah, no, Erica screws you.
Kardashian, everything they done touched them with it.
I think that's all those weak-minded people, though.
Yeah, it was some dudes. Niles, I mean...
No. Man, he didn't strong, brother.
Kim done messed up...
What strong, brother? That's it. They weren't strong. I don't think they were... Like, she didn't mess up Reggie Bush. She didn't mess up Reggie Bush.
Reggie Bush got out.
Yeah, Reggie Bush...
Reggie Bush went in, hit, and got out.
He was that dude. He didn't go into the sunken place.
Even the dude who... what was the dude she married?
The white boy? He was white.
He was talking Chris Humphrey.
Yeah, Chris Humphrey. He was a white guy.
So what?
He never had a chance.
She messed up.
Austin hit it and got on.
Yeah,
Austin,
she didn't mess
him
out.
Hit and go. Can I go spirits on y'all right quick? Because y'all talking about him being messed up and people being messed up.
Yeah.
If she done slept with all these people and them just defy y'all name, not even talking about the other people that she may have had, don't you know that she's connected? When you in a relationship sexually like that, that you become a part of that person.
Yeah,
those spirits are transferred. How many, I can't believe that, man.
The reason I can't believe that is because I don't know how many women I done slept with and who done slept with, how many men. I'm making a point.
Yeah.
I hate that.
That is a connection there.
I don't know.
Sex is the most spiritual thing.
But I'm saying,
with a person,
could that be some of it? Some of the problems that he may be having
is what? The feelings of the other people? All the other guys?
Remember, he had a video out where he had all them dudes and all them girls in the bed with each other.
Yeah, with Trump and all those people.
Everybody was in the bed, like they had in the big bed. They were like,
that was a good song.
But I'm just saying,
Rihanna.
It was something about that man here, woman there, man there. Everybody was in the bed together.
Uh-huh.
That's how basic an idea. So just think of the 500 women, let's just say 500 he done slept with, mm-hmm. and the 3,000 the 200 she done slept with.
You connect to all those people.
Yeah.
I mean, but
it's just something to think about.
Yeah, but the only thing I have about that is I don't like the idea of thinking that I'm connected with every dude and every woman that I slept with. Because I'm like, I ain't never gonna run it to dude. If I run it to dude, then I'm like, yeah, I'm connected to you. But like, plus women lie.
But
she had three, but she done had 25. Well, I'm thinking I may be connected to three. You telling me I'm connected to 25?
And then not even talking about the ones that they slept with.
And then the women that the dude slept.
Exactly.
And then the women that the dude slept. So you tell me don't have sex no more, basically. Like,
I didn't say I'm married.
Never tell that lie.
I ain't gonna never tell a little man.
I'm just saying though, it's something to think about, bro.
And you are correct because, like I say, I feel, well, sex is the most spiritual thing you will ever do with a person because you're inside of them. And
Two shall become one.
Uh-huh.
For a few minutes.
So you're doing fractions, huh?
I ain't gonna be one forever, you know, for a few minutes. Yeah. So, man, what the hell were we talking about?
Kanye. So that's the only thing that you were talking about with Kanye was more some music.
Well, no, that's, I mean, for
so that's
for,
yeah, that's your
for
issue.
For my issue when it comes down, if I have any, that's something I really don't have a problem with Kanye.
Yeah. Okay.
But if there was something, that would be it.
It'd be the music.
Yeah, okay. It would be the music.
Cool.
Because this last little piece of music is trash.
Some people liked it. I didn't even hear the album.
But I believe Kanye, he has a, just like we were talking about Jay Electronica, he has a cult following. Kanye has a cult following. Kanye can go on and say,
Kanye's setting y'all up.
For what?
To buy with his next product.
His next album is going to be...
Five? No,
classic.
It's not. No, it's not.
You think it is?
But watch this though.
Because he's with
Drake? Because
of the fact that this is new to him.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, the Jesus Walk song, Kanye did that record because he said nobody
will let him play. Yeah.
Within secular mainstream
mm-hmm.
did a record like that.
Yeah.
And he said why he did it. He said, I ain't trying to convert nobody. I just feel like this is what's needed because it was a void, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
This time, he's becoming a Christian,
mm-hmm.
right? He doesn't know what market.
Do you think what Kanye is doing right now is going to help the Christian rap market? Because, you know,
I don't think
there's been Christian rappers out there for the longest who can't get on a higher playing field.
I don't think it's going to help the Christian rap market.
Good.
Okay.
Because of the
some of them are good.
And some of them are trash.
It's not that it's not good. It's the fact that it won't help it because the vast majority of Christians, from what I've seen,
mm-hmm.
are against him.
Okay.
So we know that Mace tried that.
Yeah.
Right, Mace tried it,
but the album that he put out
after he became a pastor was like a positive album.
Yeah,
and see, people don't like positive.
No, it wasn't that.
I don't think it's people don't. And I'm a back
up. The church has not fully embraced Christian rap.
Yep. I think so too. I agree.
The church haven't embraced that
because of all the negative connotations.
No, it's just the church. The vast majority of the church
is too worldly.
They view it as worldly music.
Yeah.
Okay.
No matter what you're talking about,
some of that old tradition still ain't. They're not. But
here's the thing. You have an artist by the name of Lecrae.
Yeah, I know. That's who I'm thinking of. Yeah, dude's nice. He's nice.
But listen, what Lecrae did.
But isn't he? Okay, go ahead, man.
Lecrae didn't go after the black church the way Christian rappers started. The Christian rappers started and thought that the black church would embrace them. Mm-hmm. Lecrae went straight to the white church.
The white church
got behind him.
Smart.
And not only did he go to the white church, but he went to a particular white community.
Mm-hmm.
Calvinists.
Yeah.
Calvinism is one of the biggest white Christian sects there
I
is.
I don't even know what Calvinism is. When you say Calvinism, I'm thinking like people who follow the comic strip Calvin.
No, well, it's a
Calvin and Hall.
That's hard.
It's a But basically, John Calvin was a guy who went against the Catholic Church. He was part of the Catholic Church, went against the Catholic Church. He put together a 9-to-5 thesis with the issue that he had with the Catholic Church, which supposedly formed the Protestant movement.
So now, so like you're saying, Lecrae was the person I know, but now isn't Lecrae also going back to doing, now I think someone told me, a friend of mine told me that Lecrae was doing Christian rap, but Lecrae is also doing worldly rap.
No,
that's not true.
I wouldn't say it's worldly rap. Okay. I would say, well, according to the church, according to the Calvinist church standards, with some white people, it would be worldly.
Okay.
But when you listen to it, it's like he's doing some positive.
Positive.
Yeah, because it, even the song he got that I play with, what's the boy from the West Coast?
California.
The
Blessed.
The song called Blessed.
Mm-hmm. Right.
I mean, you would think that him and this guy, but it's all positive. It ain't nothing.
Yeah, like have fun, like kind of.
Yeah.
But still, he's changed a little bit because I was a big fan of, and I still listen to by some of his music. I started out with the first one that he came out with, that first song. I think he had something called More or Rehab.
Yeah.
He had a Rehab. That's when I first learned about Lecrae. Most of his music back then was, you know, scripture, Jesus, Lord, you know, and now it's gotten more spiritual and positive.
Okay.
As opposed to being like with the message.
Yeah.
Cause some people had a issue, some other industry people had issues with him for a second. Say, hey man, you don't, you know, start like Bizzle. Bizzle started calling him out. Like on some people that was with him. I think Dayton called him out as well.
It wasn't so much a Dayton.
Not them personally,
I mean, Dayton did. They was a part of the Christian rap community kind of came at Lecrae because he was saying he was using it as an evangelized type thing where he would link up with guys like Kendrick Lamar and all these guys.
Yeah, and that's what I'm saying.
So the church had a problem with that.
See, that's what I'm talking about when I say worldly, when he started going out with those rappers.
Right,
who were, the only thing I can say is worldly.
Right, right, I understand.
Well, same thing people said about Snoop's Bible album.
The church bought his album.
Snoop got a Bible album?
Snoop has a whole
Bible album.
No, he collabed. The thing is, he collabed with some big names, Rance Allen, Marvin Sapp.
Snoop has a gospel album.
He got some gospel album.
Full fledged gospel.
Okay, I gotta hear this.
I think he won a Grammy. Didn't he win a Grammy?
He sold over a million records.
Yeah. Okay, I gotta listen.
But guess what? The church bought it.
Now let me ask y'all a question.
They banged on Lecrae, but they bought his album.
Everybody loves Snoop. Let me ask y'all a question before we go to a break. Do y'all think the world, and when I say the world, I really mean the black community, and I hate that term, black community, I swear I hate that term, but do y'all think the black community is ready for positive rap?
Don't answer it yet.
We're gonna talk about what's going on when we come back. We gotta talk about that video. So let's sum this in this right now. We gotta talk about that video after this. So do y'all think
I would say we have the black church has passed the infant stage, and it's moving in that direction.
So we're ready for black positive rap on the radio.
You better be, because I got some music out.
What'd you say?
No, but I'm just saying, the infant stages have passed.
Okay.
So are you asking, is the church?
No, not the church.
The secular industry.
I'm saying the black, I hate the term black community, because that's what we turn into the radio station. Right. I'm talking about that listener who's, that black driver who's listening to the V103, 107.9, 99.5, 99.7, whatever radio station, to turn on and listen to positive rap.
They doing it
not
now.
Not necessarily Christian, but positive rap.
They've been doing it with Coco Brother.
Coco Brother was gospel.
But I'm just saying, he had that show that was playing
rap music. But they got him up off. But they got him up off of one of them.
But now they got the other young. What the boy? The other.
It was gospel though. The spirit of hip hop was still gospel.
Man, that was on Sundays only though.
Yeah,
right?
But I'm talking about
working
up there.
But
it was still gospel.
But weren't they still playing rap music?
Yeah, they were playing rap music, but they was playing gospel records by your favorite rapper.
Was that only one day? Was that only on Sundays, or was that?
I'm saying the evening time
on Sunday.
All right, so
Sunday,
what I'm talking about is daily. Like right now, how they play Future. Right now, how they play what's the Migos. Right now, how they play Nicki Minaj's. Are they ready? Is the black folks ready to accept positive rap and no longer the twerk rap?
Black people are ready to accept any type of music that the radio puts on the radio.
What you say, Rick?
I agree with him because the thing about the radio is it changes your thought. It shapes your thought. So okay. If a program director started to put that music on,
people are gonna listen.
Yeah, just like with Kirk Franklin with Stomp.
But yeah, that's the problem.
They were mixing Stomp in the club, right in between.
That's the problem. There's no
right in between
platform.
Luke and Drop It Like It Hot. You Stomp.
But there's no platform for that though, because you're not gonna get that unless it's syndicated radio, unless you're playing on iTunes or Amazon Market or Pandora. Yeah. There's no platform. Like say for instance in Atlanta, the only gospel radio station we have in here is 102.5 and Love 860.
Yeah.
That's it. We push some of that music when doing our show. You know what I'm saying? But you're not going to hear some of that music mainstream because there's no platform for
it. Let's take a break real quick. When we come back, we're going to talk about this video that you sent to us that was from The Breakfast Club, an interview from The Breakfast Club. LGBTQ people, this is for you guys.
Did you watch that?
Yes, I saw the clip.
Old exposed them zips. Too many tongues they can hate. Got more stress marks than these hoes. Hollering they got rank. See Sega ain't in this new world. Alter them experimenting in Atlanta, Georgia. United Nations overseas. Train assassins do search and seize. Ain't knocking or asking. Department folks like me. Whole white trash like they. Tricks like hugs. Back in slavery. Concentration camps laced with gas tight eyes. Infernos outdoors like they had back when they don't. Hitler was living in 1945. Listen to me now, believe me later on. In the future, look it up, where it said in the Constitution that in the event of a war, places like Operation Heartbreak Hotel, moments tell until that tight vent seal off this bell. They'll say it's fake, no mercy. Fool, you should be my least worries. Got a deal with W-2-10-99. Small more black helicopters swoop down and try to put missiles in my.
Who's there kicking in my window?
Nobody now.
Who's there kicking in my window?
Nobody
now. Me and my family moved in our apartment complex. A gate with the serial code was put up next. They claim that this community is so drug free. But it don't look that way to me, cause I can see the young bloods hanging out at the store. 24/7 drunk is looking for a head of the blow. It's powerful. Oh, you know what else they trying to do? Make a curfew, especially for me and you. The traces of the new world order. Time is getting shorter. If we don't get prepared, people, it's gonna be a slaughter. My mind won't allow me to not be curious. My folk don't understand, so they don't take it serious. But every now and then I wonder if the gate was put up to keep mine out of keep eye.
Who's there peeking in my window? Nobody. Who's there peeking in my window? Nobody.
Listen up, little
man. Because what they say to us is that we are for you, but don't
be going through
10% of the population. Or if you get smart, we'll wipe you out.
Now we talk about true equality.
They tell me kick that mentality.
because they have no salary. Everybody want the real, but black is reality. Gotta have a vision in this dark fly society. Kingdom in the corner now, I'm glad Satan fired me. I'm on my grind, independent, spit like techno, complex, slow, metaphors with that nice flow. Hip hop full of solid and sloppy boys, I feel like Joe. The enemy is here, we gon' put chains on the dough. Nobody talk about sin, they say they preach the gospel. Turn from the wicked ways, the line of Judah common hostile. Ancient of days on this throne before the first fossil. Created the first player who brought forth the mankind roster. Thanking God when it was, hold up, wait a second. Video of the year from my sisters being donkey naked. Christian rappers won't speak up because they want a feature. Still got their old ways, nobody rocking motor beepers. Y'all should holler, scatter four corners like a Snicker. Black, brown, caramel, they try to rap, we the people. The book, I guess you wondering who the mother crooks. Squatting in that crib, hoping that the neighbors never look.
We have to tell our black brothers who are graduated from colleges that to be successful is not to get a job with IBM.
Once upon a time we were slaves, but they came liberation. Now we slaves in the spirit without the whip chasing. No indoctrination, buying cars, they call them favorite. Depreciate, turn to rust, like Rams collecting break dust. I grab the mic like a granddaddy, pop the fuss. Looking at you kids with a mug that fakes to make you hush. I'm from the west side, Duval, where them boys rush. Babylon the dash and that street preacher that you bust. This the last days, way before the first fade. Back when kids read Torah before they could go and play. If you don't like the type of truth, then get out my face. The Lord make the world big, cause haters need space. You on that numerology, calculating apologies. Gnashing teeth in hell without brushing with toothpaste gel. Satan fail, you hit man, worried about her nails. The bullet that she fired off, I watch in slow-mo sail. Oh well, this is a vaccination, occupation, demonstration. Hold up, let me make it clear, I'm putting in word. Faith without works is dead, your testimony in the hearse. 32 ways to sin, that's why your star burst.
The man grabs him and says, everything is okay. He's flitting us again. We got to tell him.
That's right.
We've got to tell him.
All in jail. We back. We back. Welcome back to Shop Talking Random Mix with King Insane and the lovely Starlight. Instead of Starlight coming in tonight, but we love Miss Lady. We have the host of Boom Radio in the house tonight.
Yo, yo.
Say what up, fellas.
Yo, yo.
What it do?
We're glad to have the folks in the house tonight. I am Will Sane behind the board. We got my man who?
It's your boy Rick Kang in the building. Now you were just talking about it with no positive music played on the radio.
Yes.
I just played a song.
That was a great song.
One out of three.
I know, but it's not played on the radio.
The truth is unpopular.
But what I'm saying is that
wow, there it is.
They don't want to play music on the radio that's going to actually make you think. I wrote a song about it a long time ago. They won't make a song that'll make you think. Instead, they make a song that'll make the ass shrink down on the pole. Watch your ass roll. That's what they want. That's all we want to do.
Mm.
Is we all? That's what all the we love that.
But you have to be good.
But we don't want. Oh, I'm great.
No, you're not.
Boy, I'll let you hit the whole verse.
You have to be good.
On the ride tonight, I'll let you hit the whole verse. Yeah. There's some words in that I gotta switch up.
You gotta change the words
yeah.
for the TV.
But what was that song we just played, man?
That song you just played was by myself. It's called Truth is Unpopular off the Handwriting on the Wall album.
Okay, where can they find it?
You can go on itsmajors.bandcamp.com. You can get that joint.
Well, you look like you're about ready to get off over there. Well, you hear that soulful.
Hey, man, I'm a soul. I'm a 70s baby. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, okay. Now,
that's one of my joints there, too.
Yes, sir. Liberation.
Yes, sir.
Liberate your mind.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Back now, Moray William Brown.
That's okay.
Yo, you sent me a video for some particular reason.
Well, I sent you that video for this reason.
What was the video? First of all,
the video was the Breakfast Club interview with Flame Monroe.
Now, Flame Monroe, for those who don't know,
please,
because I didn't know who Flame Monroe was.
Flame Monroe is a transgender. She's a transgender.
So
she's not trans. Well,
she's trans.
He's not transgender.
She's don't trans- he say
transgender or transsexual?
He said he's not transgender.
No, he's not saying transsexual.
He said he's a man.
He's a man. He's a man who's added
that's
on.
What but he
has yeah, I know. He's a man who's added on, but he hasn't taken away from.
Wait a minute, talk to me plain. He's a man
with breasts.
With breasts, but he still got a wee wee.
He still has his. Yes. And he's not getting it cut off because he's a man.
And he still sleeps. He sleeps with women.
Yeah.
He's not into men. He was with men at one time. But now he's not with men.
So he's got breasts?
Yeah. He has breasts.
Like double D's?
Yeah.
So he's basically buffing it? I don't want to see it. I take your word for it.
Yeah, he's whatever that word was.
I don't
even know what that word is. Yeah, so I can't say he is.
Now, why did you send me that? I sent you that video because about 2 weeks ago, you had such on the. I was supposed to have.
Yeah, what's up, honey?
I was supposed to have.
You had one,
honey. We had honey about a month ago. It's been a little over a month. We had honey. Yeah.
Right,
so that's why I sent you that. Uh-huh. Because of the simple fact that.
He messed you up when you saw that.
You had that on the show. And so I would have, to be honest with you, when I was scrolling on YouTube. And on the side, you know, have the suggestions. Mm-hmm. I watched one Breakfast Club interview. Then on the side, it had another one. Mm-hmm. And so I was like, this is like a dude.
Mm-hmm.
So I clicked on the video, and then I was like, oh, I didn't even watch it before I sent it to you.
Uh-huh.
So I was like, wait a minute, hold on. Rick just had this on the show. Uh-huh. So let me go ahead and just send it to him, and then I watched it.
Uh-huh.
And so when I watched it, it was some interesting things within the show.
Yes, it was.
Some things that was said.
Pull this up right.
About, you know, I'm a man, and no, you know, I wasn't. I think he said something about I wasn't born. Something, and he started saying, yeah, the LGBT trying to force their beliefs on you.
Yeah,
he said a lot of things that I felt was important. No.
Flame Monroe.
It said a lot of things. He said a lot of things on there that things that we talk about. And their thing, his thing was like, they are trying to force their beliefs on you, and that no. You know, they born this way. Basically, he was basically speaking against
a lot of.
Go ahead, Ray.
Besides some of the confusing things he was saying,
what right.
the? Yeah. The things that
I don't even want no more Jello.
The things that he said about the LGBT, ABCDQ.
Nah, we ain't doing it. LGBTQ. I'm going straight.
Community.
Well, he said that.
He's in the community, so he might can get away.
He can get away with it.
But what he said was when he said that he felt that they were force feeding, that they do a lot of force feeding. I agree with him on that wholeheartedly.
I would say that's also
with everybody. A lot of people, because that's why. Go ahead, I apologize.
Go ahead. No, say what you're saying.
Because that's the same thing where white people say about black people, and they're trying to force agendas onto white people, and that's why white people are starting to push back on some of the agendas black people.
Well, they force their whole agenda on us.
I agree. But see, that's what I'm saying. Everybody says that everybody's trying to force something on somebody. Christians say Muslims are trying to force. Muslims say Christians are trying to force. Everybody say everybody's trying to force something, except for Buddhists. But go ahead, better what you say.
How you know what Buddhists?
Buddhists don't try to.
How do you know?
Buddhists are the.
How do you know? How do you
don't
know?
Be a Buddhist.
How do you know?
Go get in the grass.
Ain't you a part time Buddhist?
I'm a part time Buddhist.
How do you know what they do?
Where my Buddhists at?
But back to Monroe.
Yes.
All right. So Monroe has said that okay, he is a man. He raises his three kids. He has two kids that are 16.
Mm-hmm.
One is 12. They asked him, hey, are those two 16-year-olds, are they twins? He said, no, I'm a full man, meaning I did dirt. I had two women pregnant at the same time.
Yes, sir.
Now, those kids live with him, and he raised them in a white community, a predominantly white community out in California. All right? Out there, they asked him, so how do you feel about, the kids and their friends coming over? He said, they call me what, Mr. Monroe?
Yeah.
Or Mr. Monroe or something.
Because
like
they
that.
Always, and he's an entertainer.
Correct.
So
they basically say
that he's a comedian, he's an entertainer, so that's the kind of way they kind of buff that.
And that's the way they've always known him,
is that.
Yeah.
And they never see him
They never see him dressed up.
Yeah.
But they got YouTube like everybody else, though, right?
Yeah, but they know he's an entertainer, though.
But I'm saying, they know he's an entertainer.
Yeah, they know he's an entertainer.
But they never see him as the woman.
Yes. He takes.
Man, you see the 10 old minutes on that thing?
He never shows up to the
house. And they say wear big clothes.
Wear big clothes. Like, you can't see. When he go to the school, he wear big clothes. Because what he said was he don't want his kids to have to answer questions for him. He don't want to make it. He want to make it as
so
them.
I'm just trying to understand because this is the first time I'm.
Yeah.
So his kids know what he is behind closed doors.
They know he's a man.
I mean, his kids know. Just so I can process it. Yeah. His kids know he has breasts.
Yes.
But they don't want everybody else at school to, I guess, ridicule them by seeing.
Yeah, he don't want them to ridicule his kids because of their dad is this. But what his kids know him as is. Yeah, he has breasts, but he's an entertainer.
So he's...
That's why the breasts are there, more so for entertainment. They're not there for a man to suck on. Or to mess around with.
I mean...
So you going... Would you go buy you some double D's?
Just no,
so you,
but I mean...
You got a million? No.
He
lived as a woman.
So
that's why he did it. He was a gay... He's a...
He was gay.
What?
Is he gonna get them?
No,
off?
No. He's okay with them.
No, he's
that's what he is. That's how he makes his money.
That's what he is.
And he said, what's his name? Marcus Parker with him. He said, whoever the man is doesn't make money.
No.
Flame Monroe makes money.
Yeah. Wow. Can I ask a question though?
Marcus signs and cuts the check.
He cashes the check.
Let me ask a question though. And they don't have to be answered on this show. Is that salvation for a person like that?
I think so. Because let me ask you a question.
That's the question.
No. Because we're not going to get to the Bible. But
yes, we are.
Because if you tell me that.
Because that look on his face telling me.
Oh, you got to tell me no?
We need to go there. Answer the question, my brother.
So, are you asking the question that is there salvation for him?
Yes.
Would Yeshua have an issue? The scripture speak against such behavior, such lifestyle.
Okay, what's the?
But it also, doesn't the scripture say, if you come to me and repent?
Yeah.
I'm asking.
Yeah, because I always heard a story.
Yeah, Yeshua want to hear more race. Yeah.
So, but the question is.
Is there a point that you can go to where salvation is void for you? Because the Bible does talk about having a reprobate mind.
But okay, here's the question.
You better get this. I think you're going
to
go in.
The question that we have to ask is, we're talking about salvation. Is he an active participant in the act of homosexuality?
No. And that's where I was going. He is with women. This is an act. This, the breast is...
Okay,
is,
but now the Bible still talks about being effeminate.
Right, but that's...
But then, now you lying. Not you, but now you lying. Because now you being a hypocrite.
Yeah, but you say that's his job.
That's how he makes money.
Okay, so a scribble is justified by scripping. She justified because she got $300,000 worth of doctor tuition up here at Emory. So her stripping is justified because she's making money.
Yeah.
I can go home. So you can go over there and work at Swingin' Riches to
pay.
I'm just saying, you can go work hard to pay your bills.
I can't go to swinging dick.
Y'all know I'm stupid before I got here.
He's right down the road from it, so when people see my truck,
Okay, the point, but I'm just saying though, because certain things we look at as, we know that that's not righteous. Okay, for a man. So, can we say that a woman is justified by selling her body, or a man for that matter, because they got to pay their bills? Is that justification? Is that enough
for Christ to overlook, for Yahshua to overlook?
That's not a question that I can answer. Now, my question would be, we all sin.
We all have sinned.
We all sin.
No, we all don't sin.
Who quit?
Who don't sin?
Okay, the Bible tells me that if he that sins is of the devil. Bible tells me that
to my recollection, there's only been three perfect people to walk
okay,
the face.
Hold on, wait a minute. Okay, if we're gonna go here now, I can.
Adam and Eve.
Okay,
were perfect.
Uh huh. Oh,
and Jesus
and Job.
Job sinned.
Job was perfect. Bible said Jesus. Job was perfect. Sinned. The Bible said Job was perfect in his generation.
You got the church.
It literally says that. Let's
define this.
Uh-huh. Let's go by the flame.
Let's define this. Can you be perfect if what's asked of you, you do that, but yet still you still are sinful? And what I mean is because when Adam fell, sin entered into the world upon mm-hmm. all men, right?
Yes.
Job is still sinful because he have a sinful nature, right?
So everyone has a sinful nature.
Casey.
But he's perfect because whatever God asked him to do, he did it. Mm-hmm. So that can make you perfect, but yet still sinful because of your nature. Not by the act of what you did, because no matter what we do, mm-hmm. we still have a sinful nature.
So your thoughts is still sinful, right?
Can be.
Well, it can be if you haven't.
So if you don't pass down them thoughts, right, and you begin to act on them.
Right. If you act on those things, or if those things enter into your heart. See, mm-hmm. the thing is, when we start talking about.
I told you, we knew this, but I can make sure the show's supposed to come on, and we can continue this conversation. But the whole thing is, we knew that this conversation, and that's why I really believe he sent me this, mm-hmm. because he knew this conversation was going to lead into this.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, because
the motive of why you do what you do can also be the issue. Like you brought up about the stripper, right? There are some people motive to, I'm going to college, I'm just doing this, I'm just trying to pay my bills. That's a different motive than somebody saying, I love the money.
Mm-hmm.
And this lusting is why I strip.
Money lusting.
Right? Yeah. It's so many different parameters of why people do things when it comes to sin.
Mm-hmm.
All it revolves around the motive of why you're doing what you're doing.
And the reason why.
Now, here's the thing. You have Flame Monroe.
Mm-hmm.
Flame's motive mm-hmm. of why he does what he does is for the money.
Okay, to take care of his kids.
But the motive is driven by the money.
Okay,
it's not the kids.
Okay,
that's where he's gonna fall in danger.
What is that? That's everybody that does everything.
No.
Okay.
Everybody's motive isn't like that.
Tell me one person whose job isn't motivated by getting the money.
Right, but
everyone's job.
But that's, we talk about salvation.
Okay, so
that doesn't violate my motive of why I work on the job that I work on.
Yeah,
is for the money. Mm-hmm. But that job doesn't take me out or cause me to compromise my biblical character mm-hmm. to make it.
So you're so okay.
That's what I'm saying.
So Flame, all right, dressing up as a female, entertaining people as a female.
Mm-hmm.
Is going to condemn that person to hell. God's going to look at that person and say, I don't care about you coming to church on Sundays. I don't care about you tithing. I don't care about you repenting on your deathbed and saying, hey, God, forgive me.
No.
You put the stipulation in there.
Let me ask a question right quick. Hold on. Are we going to continue this?
Yeah, we continue this.
Okay, so I'm gonna let y'all talk, then we're gonna go to break, and I'm gonna put the show that's supposed to go on to go out the radio so it can go out on the radio. And right. We're gonna sit here, we're gonna continue to record to here, we're gonna continue to be on here.
Okay.
So that's what I wanted. Yeah, I needed to make sure. So, because I knew that this was gonna happen. That's why.
So,
gonna,
folks, so. Stay tuned. If you're in the radio audience, you gotta go, but you can switch over to Facebook. Facebook, what's the Facebook? Talking Random Ish.
It's your page, sir.
I know, sir. I forgot.
I mean, it's your page.
You, I'll be drunk.
You're part of the page.
I'll be drunk.
Yeah, like you said, he was too.
I have a bad memory. Speak on it, Rick.
No. Please go to Talking Random Ish Facebook page. We are on Facebook Live. Because this conversation is one. This is one reason why I wanted Moray and Minister Casey in the building, because I mean these are conversations that need to be had, and I have a question for them about their church, their and with this all along. So give us a few minutes. Like I said, I'm finna go. We're gonna take a break, and we're gonna be back in one way or the other.
What we out for you radio listeners.
Thinking. There is nothing better than relaxing the days away on a soothing vacation. Unless you're saving a ton of money while you do it, stop what you're doing right now and join Hotels Etc., America's premier discount travel service. When you join Hotels Etc., you'll be able to take the same amazing vacations and stay at the same amazing hotels with discounts up to 70%. You sure you got that?
Discounts up to 70%.
Does Hotels Etc. get you deals on everything? Like cruises, car rentals, even movies, restaurants, entertainment, theme parks, and much, much more. Now you're thinking, this is going to cost me thousands. Well, think again. The low, low price will blow you away. Plus, if you join right now, you can try Hotels Etc. absolutely free for 72 hours. Wake up, people.
Try it free for 3 days.
No cost, no obligation. So now you have your vacation. And your money, too. Never pay full price again. Join Hotels Etc. right now and slash your travel and entertainment costs up to 70%. Call toll-free. 877-967-7283. 877-967-7283. Or sign up online, hotelsetc.com. That's HOTELSETC.com.
There's a lot going on in the world, and your world is always changing. That's why it's important to stay connected. The latest news, the latest entertainment, the newest music. If it's in the air or on the air, it can be in the palm of your hand, wherever you are, with the iHeartRadio app.
iHeartRadio.
Over 1,500 live radio stations from across the country, and over 15 million songs to create your own custom stations. Text IHR to 45495 to download the app or listen at iHeartRadio.com. Standard text and data rates apply.
You're tuned into WWWE Lakeville, AM 1100.
The opinions expressed during the sponsored programs on this station are strictly those of the program hosts, guests, and callers and are not necessarily those of Beasley Broadcast Group, this station, its staff, other advertisers, or agencies.
You're listening to
the Future Movie. Oh, we just straight.
Not the one that was reprimanded.
That's
the lie,
right?
The dude that was sleeping with his mom.
Still on the mic.
He's sleeping with his stepmom.
Still on the mic.
He's talking about high school. These folks out here, some folks you have to turn over.
Okay.
Hey, so we back with this conversation.
What about the one with the reprobate mind, though?
Hold up. So for those out here, do we need to take that out? Let me know on Facebook Live
if y'all can hear us or not on the mic. If y'all can't hear us, I need to unplug that. But if not,
then we need to unplug that.
Yeah, if not, we good.
Out there, Bruce Jenner. He don't want to got breast. He don't got it. We cut out.
No, he don't. He's not.
The people that are.
And he still messes with me. Also.
And men.
No,
I think he's best with women.
So you're a lesbian now. You still wrong.
So we had a conversation. Right? Like, hold on. Before I came here, I had a conversation with Rick. And I told Rick that I knew someone. All right. So it was like, inside, they've always felt, they felt like they were a woman. They felt like a woman. All right. So what they did was, as they got older, got more money, they changed. They got the sex change. Well, when I say sex change, excuse me. They added the breast. Still got the penis. And they feel like women, but I, the person, feel like I'm a female. So I'm now of a changed mind as to how can I do my God said I'm not supposed to judge. So I'm not gonna judge that person and say, oh, you wrong for what you did.
That's not what he said. He said don't judge lest you be judged. Cause with let me finish. For with the same paraphrase, for with the same level of judgment that you judge somebody, mm-hmm. the same is going to be judged unto you. Yeah. So if I'm judging you righteously by the book, that's a righteous judgment. It's different if I'm looking at you and passing prejudgment on you and I don't know. If I judge you and show mercy in that, then I'm going to be judged and somebody's going to show me mercy. The fact of the matter is, if somebody's saying that, then what you're actually saying is that God is not fair. God is not righteous and he don't know what he's doing. He made a mistake when he put you in a man's body but gave you a feminine nature. That's what you're saying.
And I can believe that. Because you can't tell me.
But God is not a man that he should lie. No, the son of man that he should pick. God don't make no mistake.
Well, yeah, I guess he did.
So somebody lying. No, somebody lying and ain't him.
If you're telling me that, if you cannot tell me that, okay, that person who says that, hey, ever since I was a kid, I felt this way.
Then you've been under some spiritual attack since you was a kid.
Okay, so.
So you believe that a person is born gay?
Yes. I believe that a person can be born gay.
How?
All right, here's the thing, because I believe the same way. Okay, here's what I believe. I believe gay is a choice. I feel.
Wait a minute.
Let me explain to you.
All right.
I feel the act of gay is a choice. Just like I feel the act of being heterosexual is a choice. You choose not to sleep with a woman. I mean, sleep with a man.
Being heterosexual, that's not a choice.
That's nature.
It's a choice.
That's
though.
A nature.
Right now, you can go sleep with a man if you want to. That's still your choice that you make. It's all.
But I'm
choice.
Designed to sleep with a woman.
I don't care what you're designed about, but your act is your choice. It's not about what you're designed to do. Yeah, you design men. Some men are. You say, oh, we all designed to procreate.
That's how God designed men.
Why do some men shoot blanks? Did God make a mistake when some men shot blanks?
No, because God is
when
the one that gives life.
He's the one that gives life.
Okay. He's the one that ordains give life.
So did God make a mistake when he made this man to where he can't make no kids?
No.
Okay, so then he wasn't supposed to make kids. So
exactly.
Then, so then when science comes along and gives that man the opportunity.
So now science supersedes God?
I guess so, because if God
made not in my book.
If God made it to where you can't make a kid, but now science got it to where you can make a kid, then did God make a mistake or not?
No.
Or was it that man was never supposed to make a kid?
No. No.
So you saying that man was never supposed to make a kid?
No, it's not the issue with the man.
Okay.
It's not even because God is science too.
Okay, let me ask y'all. No, we're gonna stop.
Let me get it right here.
Because I'm gonna twist you right now. Okay. So you're telling me that when God made Jeremy, all right?
Okay.
And Jeremy is shooting blanks.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So now Jeremy goes to the scientist.
Mm-hmm.
The scientist says, Jeremy, I got you fixed. As a matter of fact, I can make you be able to make a baby. Mm-hmm. So Jeremy is fixed by this man.
Mm-hmm.
All right. By a man, not God. You saying God didn't make a mistake. Because when God made Jeremy to where God, where Jeremy was just making blank, God didn't make a mistake, right?
Of course.
Okay, so you saying Jeremy was never supposed to have kids then?
No, because God worked through man.
And
so the knowledge that
so
the doctor
had.
So
then why did God not just give Jeremy the right instead of making Jeremy have to go to the science guy?
Because God's still the same. It doesn't matter if the man is born with the ability or if the doctor give him the wisdom. Because where did the doctor get the wisdom from?
Books.
Where the person who wrote the book got the wisdom from?
Trial and error.
Okay, so who gave them the idea?
If I keep cutting you on your neck and I realize the first time it ain't gonna kill you,
because everybody can't cut,
mm-hmm.
and everybody can't be a doctor.
I agree.
So therefore, that logic goes out of the window.
Okay, I got a question.
At the end of the day,
I got a question.
No,
okay.
when you're in the womb.
Okay.
They say that you have both genitalia.
I believe that.
You do.
I ain't never seen it.
You do. Because the
seed. Negro, no, you ain't never seen it because you ain't never been in there.
Because the seed.
So who is they? Who is they? Have they seen it?
No, because you do. Because think about it. The woman carries the egg. She doesn't carry life.
No.
The man does.
Yeah, because life is
so,
blood.
Right. So here's the thing. Whatever gets into the egg, that sperm consists of two different
it's a chromosome.
Chromosome, okay. Right? So there's a male and a female.
Yeah, but that's right? A male and a female. Chromosome, but not necessarily sexual organs.
What determines sex? What determines your sexual
God.
Orientation?
God.
That's true. I mean, that's true.
God.
But in the grand scheme of things, we can say all things
are
God. Here's the dog question.
My first time I had sex, I didn't know I was going to have a boy.
You had to have, keep your head up, though.
Negro.
I didn't know I had a boy.
You had to put socks on.
Hey, can everybody say this real quick?
Negro. I had my socks on.
Lighthearted real quick. Think about when you made that boy. Did y'all have your head up and down?
I don't know. I don't know. She said she snuck me. She said she snuck me. She said she planned out.
Only person I ever had in my life. First time we ever had sex, she got pregnant. Well, not the first time I had. First time she ever had sex, she got pregnant.
You don't remember when y'all did it?
My oldest son. Yeah, I remember we did it.
Was your head up?
My head was in the pillow.
God, doesn't that guy lie to me? It worked for me. God told me you got to keep your head up. Keep your head down.
I don't know. She claimed she snuck me. She had it all planned.
Back to
what I was saying.
Did Adam have his head up?
Because you asked the question, do I think that you're born gay? You asked him that question.
Yeah.
Now, I don't know if you're born gay or not. I don't know what the hell this child over here doing.
I've been saying
like a badass child.
I got water in here and I'm trying to get the water.
It's like a badass child.
It's in the seal.
There's water.
Take it out. Yeah, it don't come out.
No, it's inside the seal. You got to turn it over.
You're like a badass child over there, man.
Back to the conversation.
Okay, you asked the question, did he believe that people are born gay?
Yeah.
I don't know. And one of the reasons why I don't know is because when you are in the development stage, you do have both. And there has been proven that some people are born with both.
Hermaphrodite, don't they call them hermaphrodites?
Yes. Yeah. Now, so what if you're born with both.
I didn't make no mistake with that one. So which one are you supposed to just choose? Flip a coin? When you go with. Am I supposed to cut it off or sew it up?
Okay, so now we're talking about. We're asked. The question is, and the conversation is about you being born with the desire
to be with the same sex.
So if you got both of them.
No, it's not even about what part you have.
No, yeah, okay.
The question is this. When a child is born, right? Does a child have the senses and the ability to know its desires?
No.
They develop them over time. Like when you're the infant, no, you don't know.
But you said they're born gay.
Yes.
Which means if they're born that way.
Okay, I see what you're saying.
That they have to have those. They have to have the senses.
Then it goes back to what I'm saying then. It's a choice. It's the same thing as heterosexual. When you're not born heterosexual.
You got to take being born gay off the
table. Okay, then take off being born heterosexual.
It's a choice.
So you're just born.
Then we got to go back to design, the way he designed
us. I don't care about the design, bro.
I mean, male or female.
We don't talk about most dogs people, and all that.
Most people that were born, and most people, the parents shape the mind of the child. How do we know this?
We're going to say most, okay.
Simply because if you look at the study, most men that become gay outside of the reasoning of molestation, most of them were never corrected by even the toys that they played with.
Okay, let me ask you, why do you have to correct someone because of toys that they want to play
because
with?
Because a child doesn't know.
Okay, so then why do you interfere with that then? Is one of my questions.
Because I'm shaping the child of what this child is born to be. Because
you're shaping the child to be what you want it to be.
What do you mean what I want it to be?
So if a child is born with a penis, But you want a daughter, so you're going to start
just
your...
No, I didn't say that.
Yo, the animal kingdom don't even do what you say.
Okay, let me see what you...
The animal kingdom even takes... When they have a male child, they train them to hunt differently than a daughter.
But they have, but there's gay in the animal kingdom.
No.
They do hunt each other.
That's nature. It's very rare.
What you say? But they have proven that there have been animals.
Yes.
That
yes.
Shoot it, but it's rare.
But we're talking about
mankind who's greater than the animal.
Okay. Let me. Go ahead.
Okay. What about the little boy that you are shaping, but no matter how you shape him, he still is attracted to men? You got football players that went off playing in the NFL.
All they like,
they had to put the ball in their hand. They took the ball out of their hand, gave him the ball, did manly things with him.
No.
But he was a...
Huh? Hey, come on, bro. You can't do it now.
Wait a minute. So you're telling me, answer this question. So you mean to tell me that there are no boys that have been trained in the way of being a young man that has not ended up gay? Is that what you're telling me?
There have been men that have played male sports that have gone on to be with men. Absolutely. But we're talking about raising a child outside of sport.
No, you're talking about sport.
No,
I just asked.
Sports don't dictate sexuality.
That's why I didn't say sport.
Yeah, because you didn't let him be a ballerina.
What I said was, there have been men.
I brought up sports for a reason. Because you said take the ball away from him and give the ball in the hand. That's why I said sport.
Right. Yeah.
Now, so you mean to tell me that there are not little boys that has been raised by men that have taught them to do manly things, that had the cold conversations about this is what you do, this is da-da-da-da-da-da-da, as being a man. And they still turn out gay. That don't happen.
Show me one.
Really show me
one. I'm just saying, show me one. What was the path? What was the path from the time the child was born? What was the path from the time the child was born until they became their ability to know the difference between white, right and wrong?
I know path? Some, and y'all gonna think this is the craziest thing. I know some Jehovah's Witnesses kids who's raised by the Bible.
That's not the same Bible.
All of them have been remixed. And next time you I promise you, the next time you come anywhere near me, I'm gonna bring a Jehovah's Witness Bible, a King James version of the Bible. I actually have it on my phone. Every Bible that is for what has been translated to them.
I actually have the Bible up on my phone.
Not
the Jehovah's Witness.
With over 50 translations, and I can tell you that they're not the same.
They're not the same. Okay. Can I ask a question though? Sure. Watch this. Is a child born a murderer?
No.
We don't. I'm going somewhere with this. That's a valid question.
It's a valid question.
But we don't know. Is a child born a murderer? No, absolutely, because a child does not know.
Yeah.
A six month old child. Let's say when a child usually start to walk.
Let's say around about a year.
About a year. A child that's walking a year old or going to the grocery store and just see something and will pick it up and walk out the store with it but not knowing that that's wrong.
Yeah.
So you have to train them.
Okay, that's a crime. Is it a crime for a kid to play with a dog? Listen, don't change the context. I'm not talking about stealing.
Okay. I'm saying that a child at that innocent age at 12 months old will walk in the store and pick up a shiny bag or whatever and walk out the store with it, not knowing that that's wrong.
Because why is it wrong?
Let me finish. You're taking a conversation while I'm not going. You're hopping on it. That's not what I'm going with. Let him finish. That child at that age does not know that that's wrong from taking something, first of all, that's not paid for, that's stealing. The point is they don't know. So you trying to tell me that same child at 12 months don't know that you picking up something and taking it that's wrong, but now you a boy, you telling me that you know you want to be with a boy?
Okay,
at 12 months old?
You're talking about a crime and something that's not a crime.
Yeah, I made the point. You're missing the point.
No, I'm not missing the point.
You're missing the point.
You're telling us. No.
You're missing the point.
Stop.
I'm telling you what my point is.
Here's why your point is.
No, you. What is my point?
Because you're talking apples and oranges. Here's why you're talking apples and oranges.
How am I talking apples and oranges? I'm just talking about learning.
Let me apples and oranges.
Okay.
You talked about one thing that is definitely a crime. The other thing is what I don't want you to
listen, be. No. I'm talking about focusing on the stealing. Bro, you're focusing on the stealing. I'm not talking about the stealing. I'm talking about the fact that
what
it
is
doesn't.
Actually wrong?
Listen. I'm talking about the fact that the child does not know.
Okay, well, let me
ask
you.
That's the whole purpose for the child at 12 months old does not know that I cannot, that I'm not supposed to pick this up. That same child does not have the mental capacity to know whether they want to be with a man or a woman or a girl.
Not at one. Not
exactly. One. So where does that child come from? Where does that consciousness begins to be shaped? Notice I said shape because at 12 we don't know. So that means at some point of time, something outside that child has to come in and shape them.
By the time the child reaches 12, mm-hmm. a child has some level of capacity of knowing right from wrong.
We talking about, he said 12 months, not what? 12. No, talking about 12 months.
But between the ages of 5 and 8 is when a child start trying to experiment on how far they can go with what's right and wrong.
So at three years old, a child still don't know.
Correct.
A child don't even know how to put his shoes on right from left.
Don't even know how to.
Exactly. So then that means a child cannot be born gay.
He took that off the table.
No. I'm just saying you cannot be.
But his thing was is we're shaping them to be what we want them to be.
According to how God made them. If he made a boy and a girl,
let me ask you this. I had this conversation with a guy and I asked him, when did you know? He said, because he didn't grow up gay. He was with girls. It did nothing for him. It didn't please him. It didn't turn him on. Nothing. Try the guy. It pleased him. It turned him on. It gave him all the desires that we get from women.
Now, when did he try the girl?
In high school.
Okay, he's past the age. He's past the age. By the time you reach 12,
okay.
You know.
I get what you're saying.
You know where you at by the time you reach 12.
But if you don't turn you on.
But
he tried. He kept trying.
He said he tried in high school to be with girls.
But it wasn't getting to
it. Didn't.
He tried in high school. But between the time of his teenage, by the time he turned 13, from between 5 and 13, mm-hmm. what was it? What? Because it's your shaping starts by the time you hit 3 years old. You begin to shape your children.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So what was his parents? Was he a single? Was he did his mama raise him? Was he raised around a lot of girls?
My mama raised me, and I was raised around a lot of girls.
I'm not using that as an excuse. I'm not saying that. I'm not saying that. I'm asking the question mm-hmm. because these are things that's been opposed mm-hmm. to why men become gay.
Okay,
that's not what I'm saying.
I get what you're saying.
But I'm saying...
I can put it back in...
one of y'all households. Not saying your household, okay. Casey.
I can talk about my. I know you're not, but I'm saying I can tell you something that's in my household, and you can see to validate what I'm about to say.
This has also happened. Well, the man was there, a strong man, showed him how to be a manly man, to grow up to be a man, and he still ended up gay.
Something still had to happen, though, Rick. Nothing from nothing leaves nothing. Had to do something, motherfucker punch you in the mouth. That's what Eddie Murphy said. Nothing for nothing leaves nothing, bro.
And there's a...
So you trying to tell me... So either two things...
Too many... It's a lot of variables.
It's a lot of variables.
It's a lot of variables.
Yes.
One main thing is, though, bro.
My whole thing is...
If somebody can turn like that, then we have to say that the God, the Most High, whatever you subscribe to, don't know what he's doing. Because if I can be born some way, and then all of a sudden I can just... I don't think it's all of a sudden.
I'm still not going to say, even what Rick is saying, because there's a lot of variables, I'm still not going to say he was born that.
Born, exactly. I can't.
Because he doesn't know.
And like I said, everything is a choice. But let me ask, here's my question. Here's my question about this Bible thing. All right, everybody gets stuck with this. He's in the Bible that homosexual is wrong. Who said that? Don't tell me God said that. What man wrote God dang on down that it's wrong for men to sleep with men?
Moses.
Okay, did Moses actually write that down?
God gave it to him.
Okay, so God, so you
told
agree
him
with
not
that.
To sleep with womankind and men, like a man kind.
So now I'm asking you agree with that?
Keep going.
I need to know, because I don't know. I'm not, this ain't stump the chump, because what I look at it is that we don't know for sure. Here go Rick and Will getting together and writing a book. And we writing down the book and say, you know what? Men sleeping with men, that's wrong.
We tell you why it's wrong.
And then we
can I break it down to you real simple? Can I break it down to you real simple?
Follow it as if this is the way it has to be.
Let me break it down to you real simple.
Why not just wait till you die and find out what God
said? Let's break it down real simple. God gave a man a penis to do what?
Appropriate.
To sow seed. Because, wait a minute, because I'm going.
Not this everybody.
This is life. I'm just saying, but general, man has a penis to sow seed.
Okay.
Right? To give life.
Okay.
A woman has a womb mm-hmm. to hold and culture and nurture life. A man's butthole, a woman's butthole, is a waste. Hold on. It's a wasteland that deposits.
Same thing with
vagina. Hold on, let me finish. That has nothing but decay, decrepit. It's the deposit, right?
Same thing with the vagina.
Let me finish the point. Because I ain't finished. Let me finish.
And I'm going to come back.
But let me finish it, though. I don't believe that God will create me and give me something that gives life, designs a woman so that I can put what this supposed to be into something that cultivates life. That's how it's supposed to be. There's no way he gonna allow me to put something that gives life in a dead situation. An anus only secretes out something that's waste.
Okay.
That's a dead situation. It's not meant for my seed to go into a dead situation. It would not bring forth life. That's not natural.
Hold on.
What about the mouth?
That's not natural either, bro.
Okay, let me ask you a question.
Whatever evil sexual desires you have because of the lust of your flesh.
Let me ask you a question.
And I've been there too. That's fine, but it wasn't designed to procreate life.
Okay, let me ask you this question. And this is on a strictly, if sex wasn't supposed to be nothing else but to procreate,
exactly.
Why in the hell is it so enjoyable?
Thank you.
And
it's in the
stop.
You told me I can only use this.
Also in the rectum, it is proven. Man's G spot is in his rectum.
Okay.
That's what they tell you.
My question would be, why in the hell would he make a place that's a dead end and ain't supposed to have nothing done to it? Why would he put the pleasure there?
Pleasure not there.
The pleasure's not there, brother. Pleasure's in your flesh.
The pleasure not there. Do you get off without somebody having to
stick a finger in your butthole?
Yes, but some men have.
No, you do. I'm asking a question.
I do.
A man can. A man
can rub against this table a little
man,
bit.
Right. A man gets off because. Because create the.
He's designed to
let me just take God out of the equation.
Okay.
Let's deal with science. Okay. Scientifically, a man gets off because of the sensors on his head. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Right?
I got you. Yep.
Okay. So his testicles is also connected to parts of his rectum.
Yep.
The goop.
Right. Yep. So you ask, you say, well, why God would put. Because of the fact that the way he designed the body,
he still didn't design because when you decide
to take a dump, mm-hmm. your dump doesn't go pad or touch your G spot. Mm-hmm. It don't touch it.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, then why is the G spot down?
Because it's built near the.
No, why do you give it to him?
No. What do you mean?
Why do God give a man a G spot in his rectum if it's,
it's not in the rectum?
Okay, why?
That's what I'm telling you.
How do you access it?
They access it through that area.
Okay.
Right.
So what's another?
I can access parts of your body without having to go in there. If I want to touch your rib cage or touch your muscle, your rib, I can touch here and still touch your rib.
How can I get a woman to access my G spot without her putting her finger up my ass? Tell me how can I do that then.
Well, first of all, you need to make sure you mentally there. Everything starts in your mind.
That is.
Everything starts in your mind. You want a woman to get off?
No, I ain't.
No, listen, we talking about that. Listen to what I'm telling you.
Go ahead.
You want a woman to skeet?
Yeah. I know how to do it.
But here's the thing. Everything starts in the mind.
You know what I'm saying.
I start foreplay with
in
my
the morning
wife
when I get up.
Soon as I get
up
before I get out the bed,
the first thing we do is kiss.
I ain't even planning to try to even have intercourse with her.
Yeah.
At the moment, I know that by the time she get home around 6 o'clock, I need to make sure that I'm having foreplay with her.
All during the day.
I got the kids set by the time she get home, the food, everything. Because why? Because men are also mental, but women are way more mental when it comes down to the sex
thing.
You gotta stimulate their mind. But as a man, if you want to get off,
you can get off, but you got to.
If you want your G spot to get off, it also starts in your mind. And not only that, you have to also be thinking more so about her getting her off than yourself. Most men worry about more about getting off themselves than the woman.
Bro, you still ain't answering the question. Okay, you just.
What do you mean? I'm asking the question.
He won't know.
How you get the question? And I.
You can't answer the question. You can't.
That's diverse.
No, listen. You can't get to the G spot no other way.
Then why
because
is
the way
it
is access. The G spot was never created for you even to get off in that manner anyway.
Listen, what I'm saying.
You can get off by where the sensors are already at.
I get what you're saying.
100% get what you're saying.
Why do I need it? Answer the question.
What is the damn purpose for having a G spot
there? First of all, the G spot, that's a terminology that science has made.
Here we go.
Okay, answer the question.
But
we got it.
But listen, okay, so have you ever
I have had my salad talk. So what is the purpose?
Very uncomfortable.
What is the purpose of you needing your G spot?
I don't need it.
So why are you asking the question?
Why do we have it here?
Because
we are the same conversation. Why did God give it? Okay. God is perfect. All right? God made you.
Okay.
And God makes no mistakes.
God makes no mistakes. He put that
that's
in your...
That's not a mistake.
Okay.
So what the hell is it done for then?
No, stop, Rick.
Because...
Let's break down elementary for you. So God put this little spot in your ass.
I got a
little... Where the finger goes in your ass.
No.
No, listen.
It's not there, though, in your butt.
Okay. So that's what you access. So if your finger goes in your ass and she touches that, all right, then that can make you feel pleasure. All right. So now what we're asking... why is that even there then?
You know what?
The same reason your nipple is here and your wife can suck your nipple and give you pleasure.
You know when your G spot is stimulated?
It's not supposed to be accessed. You're not supposed to do anything with
your anal.
I'm gonna tell you. Do you know when your G spot is stimulated? I'm gonna tell you when. After you bust a nut, right?
Mm-hmm.
Do you have energy?
No.
Your G spot has been massaged. That's why men don't have energy.
My ass don't feel no.
So when you butt,
But it's been said that. But it's been said that if someone activates or play with your G spot.
Man, that was them sissies say.
Women say this.
Women will tell you this. Women will tell you.
Women
will tell you. But women will tell you.
It's not in a rectum.
No.
Why is it in a man's ass?
No. Look,
because you don't have a vagina.
It's in the same spot. Okay, but hers is supposed to be played with.
No. Listen. Y'all talking crazy.
You know why you're talking crazy?
Why are we talking?
It's because crazy? a woman don't need to have an orgasm just for you to hit the G spot. So why? But here's the thing. It's in the same spot.
Just say you don't know why God put that.
No, but no. You know why? I mean, I ain't even talking about God because, first of all, you took that off the table. So I'm talking to you scientifically. So don't talk to me about God.
Okay, scientifically about God.
Y'all getting this, right? Y'all getting this.
The perp is there to it connects to your scrotum. Okay? It connects to your scrotum and it also allows certain fluids to pump into your rectum.
Here.
That's the purpose for it. Okay. It's no different than a pancreas. You asking why would he even create a pancreas?
Here's the question.
Or a kidney.
If a female takes her finger right now and do this to a guy, right? He doesn't get any pleasure. Alright? That won't take the same.
Do it where?
Stop.
No, do it where?
She puts it right here.
In the hand, right?
He doesn't get any pleasure.
Right.
If she takes that same finger. Sticks it in his rectum. What you saying that's a dead space? That donut's supposed to go in, aren't they supposed to go out?
Isn't that the truth?
Okay,
huh? It's not in the rectum.
You gotta go through.
You have to go through the rectum.
But it's not
to get it,
in the rectum.
No, how much?
How much more do you need?
It's still not in the rectum.
It's not in the rectum.
I know it's not in the rectum.
Because how do you get to it?
Because you can't get you.
First of all, that's not the so-called G spot. You don't have to hit a G spot for men to bust. I'm not saying we know this.
You can bust by hitting.
Hey, we so simple. You can bust by rubbing up. So that's
here's the thing. The woman is in her vagina towards the top.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Right. In the front toward the top, mm-hmm. which is connected to her clitoris.
Mm-hmm.
The same way I just explained to you that it's connected to your testicle, right? The only reason why you can't get to it is because you don't have a hole in there.
Why have you?
But it's not the...
Why have you?
Lord,
have y'all still ain't answered the question.
Why did you go?
I'm not even discussing this. What they doing is they're on that whole... thing that's out there that says you can hit a man's G spot through his butt.
I am not.
Hold on. Undercoverly, Them niggas want their G-spot hit because they want to know what it feel like. But they don't want nobody to grow up in that butthole. Because he already asked the question, how can you hit my G-spot without a woman going through my butthole?
You can't.
You can't. Okay. So don't take it off the table. I can bust a nut. You ain't got to. You can say, choke my nipple. I can bust a nut.
No.
You can take that same finger and Erykah Badu can look at me with them eyes and I can bust one. You ain't got to go through my butt. But that's for them sissies. And give them sissies pleasure. To keep them in that sin.
It's easy to say that I don't know why God put it there. No, we can't have that conversation.
You took God out the table.
It's easy to say I don't know why I'm born with that spot, with that in my life. I just told you, you don't receive the answer.
Because you want to try to find a way around where the, in another
trying,
access.
I'm not trying to find
and that. You can't get there without going through because you don't have an opening down there to get to it. If man had an opening down there to get to it, then you will have to go to that, go to the rectum area. And to be honest with you, the G-spot or whatever you talking about or whatever they talking about isn't supposed to be accessed anyway. That's why he put it the way it is. You don't need, a woman don't need you to touch that G-spot for her to do that. Plain and simple.
For her to
have an orgasm. You don't need to. I tell you what, you want, I tell you what.
I know you that, I know that. But you as a man,
this is what I'm gonna tell her. And before you go there, I can tell you the way. You want to know a way? It's for your G-spot.
No, I'm going to tell you.
Because you do want to know. No, you don't want to know. I'm going to tell you.
Because you don't know.
I'm going to tell you.
Bro, it's just easy to say something that I don't know.
No. I'm going to tell you why. I'm going to tell you how you can do it.
Let me say I don't know why.
Here's how you can do it.
Go.
Go in your house. You got a beam in your house?
Yeah.
Okay. You got a beam in your basement? You got a basement? Go in your basement. Get you a chair. Not this high. Get a chair probably hide right here. Okay. To the floor.
My foot.
Put you a rope.
Mm-hmm.
Put it around your neck.
Hang it.
Yeah. You want to act? There you go. I just helped you out.
Okay.
You want to get your G-spot off?
No.
You want to kick the chair and go ahead and get that amazing...
That's right, you want a super nut. But what is the purpose of the G-spot? I'm just saying, I understand what you're saying. If you do hit, amazing things happen.
And you're going to be asked to come back.
Okay. You do this multiple times, again and again.
But you should be asked.
You're going to be asked to come back regardless. But if you hit, if it's good. But if you hit that, you get a different sound. You get a different sound. Hey, let's grab this thing, man. I gotta go. We gotta go.
I gotta get out of here.
I don't know. I can't. Hold on a minute. I can't say that it gives me pleasure.
Okay.
Woman get close to my butt, I get nervous.
I do too.
So I don't see how that can give a man pleasure. My conscience, you know what I'm saying?
That's a little too much about that.
You know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? If somebody gets
close, you don't know, bro.
No.
You
see what I'm saying? To me, that's
on Boom Radio about sin.
That's a, you know what I'm saying? So I don't know how it gives a man pleasure. But what I can say,
why would he put sin?
I would say that the enemy say whoever want to say subscribe to. Will use that in order to keep a person in that space because they'll say, oh, it gives me so much pleasure.
Man created it.
So I'll continue to get bumped up in the butthole to get that pleasure. But that's sin.
Why give him the choice?
Because you can't not be able to. That's still a dead situation.
Because if
you don't have a waste, come out your butt.
We've been waiting for everything you need.
Another waste is come out your butt.
I gotta go see if I can hear G-spot.
It's waste. Right or wrong? It's waste.
Hey, let's wrap this thing up.
Why would I want to
rap? Tell them where they can find you. Y'all
why would I want to put
tell them where they can find y'all
God's life into a dead situation?
Why tell them where they can find
y'all? Y'all don't want to deal with that.
Why tell them where they can find you. That? Tell them where they can find
man,
you.
Man, listen here. Y'all can find me right here next week. You can find me. Hey, access your boy man, Minister KCL Hewitt at YouTube.com. You can also go check him out on Amazon Music, Google Play Store, iTunes, Spotify. Check out the music.
You can check me out on YouTube.com/Boom Church or YouTube.com and just search Boom Church on that. You know what I'm saying?
and go from there.
Hey, fellas, I thank y'all once again.
Yes, yes, appreciate it.
And this ain't no...
Come here.
This ain't no... Come y'all know it ain't.
It was interesting.
This, y'all know it ain't. Whoa. I can't wait to see what happened on the first Saturday of the month.
No, no, I tell you, here you go. Get your G-spot on.
We had a whole conversation with DNA. And these guys in here as well.
Yeah,
get your G-spot on.
It's time to sweep the flow, clean the clippers. Boom radio, y'all got the bathroom.
Ain't got
the shop is closed.
Get out.
Man.
Oh, man. But this was interesting, boy. That G-spot, man. I want to ask that. My
G-spot. These are some of the things he tells me. Mr. Tucker, this president should never mention funding because that's quid pro quo, Mr. Tucker. They're entitled, Mr. Tucker. He never gave them any. I mean, the fact that he is going to say he gave them something special in the form of funding, that we should treat it as something special, that we are